Welcome to the Summit City, home to the 260's dedicated high school athletes and fans. Each victory and celebration captured by our cameras. Treasure the highlights from the Summit Athletic Conference this season, or complete games live or on demand. After all, nobody's more proud to call Fort Wayne home than SummitCitySports.com.
I decided if I was going to come to Indiana Tech, I was going to be a different kind of instructor. I was really going to focus on connecting with students, teaching the students the theory that they needed, and also the practical applications.
Very practically, what that looks like is smaller class sizes. So my class sizes are the 8 to 10 up to maybe 20. And that's backed up with, we have 18 hours of office hours every week. I'm sitting in my office waiting for students to come in to talk about anything. It doesn't just have to be with the classroom.
In the College of Engineering, we have ABET accreditation for mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, and biomedical engineering. ABET is the top accrediting board for engineering in the United States and probably in the world.
Another thing that is a very different approach at Indiana Tech, I think, than some other universities, is we try and make sure they have a lot of lab experience in the engineering department. All engineering programs are going to have laboratory courses, but in our laboratory courses, we try to get them not just exposure to measurements and exposure to some of the devices that you'll be used, but I like to actually assign projects that are, you know, realistic projects.
Those projects, this project-based learning, helps students to work together in a group and be hands-on with the material or the product that they're creating. Engineering students at Indiana Tech are, to me, stand out because I know that they've had a lot of experiences working in groups, working on projects, doing lab experiments to help them understand the material, and I think that prepares them well for industry.
First thing I'll tell a high school student is study, study, study. Get all the math you can possibly get. I honestly believe that the critical thinking skills you learn in math courses will help you with engineering courses.
The type of knowledge base that students should have coming in, they need to be problem solvers and critical thinkers. Those two things are really the essence of engineering. Regardless of flavor, they're going to need to figure out, there's a problem here, how do I solve it? And they need to think critically about that. They need to observe, listen to people, and then kick in those problem-solving skills to solve the problem.
Part of the growth of Indiana Tech has involved an increasing number of international students. So I think if we can expose students to different ideas, different cultures, again, it makes them that much more competitive in the marketplace.
In the Fort Wayne area, we have lots of large companies, BAE Systems, Fort Wayne Metals, General Motors, Raytheon, Harris Corporation, and the list goes on. We have a lot of employers that want our engineering students.
Indiana Tech, I think, continues to serve students even beyond their graduation. We really strive to keep in touch with our alumni on a personal level just to see how they're doing, but then also they want to give back to the university because of the experiences they've had here, so they want to provide opportunities for other students here as well.
Welcome inside the Sport One Parkview Ice House, day two of the WAC Men's Ice Hockey Tournament, and it's semifinal number two. We've got what should be the game of the weekend on tap. It's the 16th ranked Lawrence Tech Blue Devils. They're the number three seed this weekend, the number two seed this weekend. Their opponent is the UM-Dearborn Wolverines. They come into this one ranked 18th in the country. Big potential national tournament implications on the line in this one. And of course, that also has something to do with the WAC tournament auto bid. The winner of this game will advance to tomorrow's tournament championship game and take on the Concordia Cardinals, who took down the host Indiana Tech Warriors 4-1 here a few hours ago. But we'll get right into this matchup alongside me today. On color commentary is Bryce Ryder. Connor Hendrickson will be on the camera. My name is Joe Hacker. We do thank you so very much for joining us. And Bryce, should be a heavy hitting matchup tonight. We got to look at both of these teams yesterday. What are your kind of initial thoughts on this matchup?
Well, to me, University of Michigan Dearborn looks pretty good, and you know, we always count them in. And Lawrence Tech says, hey, we want to be in the show tomorrow, so they're going to skate this one. Now, they all got to see, as we saw, they were spectators in the game earlier, and they saw, you know, something really odd where Indiana Tech fell short. And so here, there's an opportunity for anybody to come through in this tournament really strong today.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and see what we get here. It should be a good one. The middle two seeds in the semifinals. Last weekend, these two teams came against each other as well. It was a sweep for UMD. They won games 3-2 and 4-2. They've had the advantage in this matchup all season long. From the Dearborn perspective, it's a 3-1 season series. To Lawrence Tech, it's 1-2-1. They lost one of those games in overtime. That was game number one. It took just 11 seconds for Joey Cullinan to pot the game winner. Josh McCarchuk and Heyer also with other goals. It was a 2-1 game in favor of Dearborn, but Lawrence Tech battled back and won the second game of that series 5-0. And then, of course, the two wins this past weekend for Dearborn. We'll touch on that a little bit more throughout, but we'll go ahead and pause. We'll take a look back at how these two teams got here. We'll start with a little highlight package from yesterday's game between Rochester and UM Dearborn. Ice to Bird. Bird too far in front of Cullinan. Icing is going to be waved off here. Cullinan in on the scene first with the size advantage. West over looking for Bird. Didn't take the pass. Now down low. Cullinan trying to jam at the side of the goal.
Shot.
West in front. Takes a shot and scores.
Yeah. He picked up that loose there.
UDD for Hartwell. Nice find across the seam looking for Kudenko. Kept in by O'Connell. And loose out in front for a second. Matthews, and he scores.
Yeah. Carly could not hold on, and it's a second.
In the corner, he's got two guys on him. Comes out to the point for McCarchuk. McCarchuk looking to go back door, and that is a goal. They will count it.
Yeah, Carly stretched out.
He's pressured by Potter. Battle ensues. Bird is in there. Saville comes away with it, though. And sticking with it, though, is Bird. Cullinan in there as well. Here's Cullinan. Stick handles and shoots and scores.
Him. They could not get a hold of it.
Chance pulls in. Wow. Don't think it got to him. Right out in front there. That was Conmo. Up ice for Matthews. Plays it into the open room for Kudenko, who skates into it. Stops up. Dodges the check. Goes parallel over to Hartwell. Hartwell. Nice find to Matthews. Oh. But a great save by Carlier.
Carlier looked like he was going to give that up.
Skating up ice. Nice pass over to Banks. Zalewski, he's been a tremendous player today for this Rochester team. Here's Banks trying to go right out in front. Nobody home.
Yeah, Zalewski's digging in the ice, man. He's looking good. He's
going
to get a shot off here.
Here you go. Takes a shot, and he scores!
Yeah, we called him out. He's been waiting
for well. Finds Cullinan. Cullinan, backhander. Carlier with the stop.
Wow.
Cullinan to Bird. Fans on the shot. It slid right underneath. Saville up ice the other direction. Saville knifing
got
through
moved.
A couple. Nice moves there. But Polson able to track it the whole way and eventually get the cover. Get to it off the wall and cycle it for West. West into the slot. He'll drop it for Bird. Nice play across to West. Goes high and scores.
Yeah, that was signature. We saw that on the first effort of the
across the line. Surveying, feeding to Zalewski.
Oh.
And he'll make a nice pass over to Matthews. But Matthews is in the different colored jersey. Matthews on the attack now. Goes out wide. Feeding across. Petterly hangs on and feeding and getting a goal.
Yeah, that
from
one.
From Kudenko.
Carly was everywhere on that. He thought.
Circling around. Still with it. Hartwell. We now go over to McCarchuk. McCarchuk with some traffic. It's loose right out in front. Can they find it? It's still batting around out there. Comes out to West Hill Hammer, and that one is
what a
kept
stop.
Out. All right, welcome back. It was a 6-1 win for UM Dearborn in that game against Rochester. They got two goals apiece from Brendan West, the WAC Player of the Year, and Mikhail Kudenko, a goal apiece from Chance Matthews and Joey Cullinan. Eric Polson, he gets the start again today after making 22 saves on 23 shots. Bryce, it was a little bit closer for Dearborn than we thought it was going to be, but in the end, you'll still take a 5-goal win. It's hard to say that that was too close.
Yeah, that was a good game to watch, and we thought, you know, after Tech had played Rochester that this could be a blowout, and it wouldn't help Dearborn out any because they would be playing a team that, you know, they could easily handle, not prepare them for today's game and further down if they could, you know, muster a win here. But, yeah, that was – Rochester gave them, you know, what they needed. There were times that University of Michigan was really having to skate and play hard, so I think it's prepared them for tonight. So that was – I mean, they should be really thankful for Rochester for giving them a good game.
Yeah, absolutely. A little more prepared than they thought they were going to be. And with that sweep last weekend, they got that second seed. They were able to get that matchup with Rochester, which was a little bit of a free pass into the second round. We'll have to be honest about that. Lawrence Tech, on the other hand, they take on Cleary. They win that one 6-2. Themo I with a hat trick. It was a close game for a while, though. It just kind of got broken apart in the third period by Lawrence Tech.
Yeah, and that's what I think that Lawrence Tech's got to prepare for tonight, is to forget about that you know, jumble of goals they got all in that couple of minute period, and to think that that's not going to happen tonight against this team. So they've got to prepare to not think, hey, we could burst out and, you know, stretch out a big lead. That, you know, this is a battle here that anomaly probably won't be a factor. And it could be, but I wouldn't count on it.
Yeah, we'll have to see. Josh Hickson, Blake Heyer, and Patrick McGowan, the other goals for Lawrence Tech. Levi Herhoff and Brendan Galliner with the goals. For Cleary, it was Noah Brandall in goal yesterday for the Blue Devils. It'll be Spencer Cole tonight, but we'll go ahead and move again into a highlight package. This time we'll take a look visually at how that Cleary and Lawrence Tech game played out, and when we come back, we'll get more into this matchup. Gardner off the wall, sends it on goal. It is deflected wide by Bandall getting the start tonight. Comes back to Gardner again. Shot off the crossbar.
What a shot.
And that one stays as a win over Indiana Tech, as does UMD. They are the only two conference teams who have beaten the Warriors, who have lost three games all season. Here is Wes Smith through neutral. Dodging through, still in pursuit. Wes Smith with the shot and draws a penalty to boot. Doesn't. Cougars are able to get it here. It comes out to the point for Wiener. He walks along the line and sends it down to Gledhow. Gledhow for Wiener, poked away. Here we go. Shorthanded opportunity for Lawrence Tech. Fakes and stopped by Krasovsky.
Both goalies looking good.
And the Lawrence Tech goal now. Back to even strength. All that penalty time cleared off. Directed towards the goal. Here's a shot from Thomas right there.
Wow.
They score.
Oh, man. They were just hanging on to the puck.
Here. Stops up. Gets over to Jentz, over to Ceccarini. Hem steps into one off the iron.
Rings the pipes there.
Oh, that is actually Wiener. Here is Eakes. Eakes around one. Had it poked away. Gives it to Rundle. Rundle is lit up. Herhoff down to Thomas, and now it comes out. Here, picking this one up and gaining some speed. Here, wrapping around, feeding out in front. They
Wow, coming in. Just going into the slot, blocked.
And Wafer has a player still draped all over him. Right out in front.
Goal.
And they score. Themo I again.
Wow.
Sent back down low. McBeth to the near wall. It's a bouncer. It comes off. Here's a chance for Hemi. A backhand rebound in front. And they score.
Just got Hemi.
All the way down. Gledhow has sample all over him. Heads up for Gledhow. He and Sample tangle up, and now we're going to get a penalty. That is going to be on Gledhow.
Yeah, no frustration here. He's got a broken stick, and now he's getting a second penalty.
And I think the official might have been in the line of fire on. Very good. The microphone, I don't think, is very good.
Well, I think one of them will be the unsportsman.
Here with the shot, and he scores.
Yeah. Unopposed.
It was one or two, that's one thing, but I feel like there are like five that are questionable. So. Looking for another one. They almost get it, and they do.
Wow, so this one, boy, I tell you, what a game.
All right.
It's just 2 minutes, so.
11-12, still to go in this one. I in pursuit. He wants another one. Themo I, does he get it? Yes,
he does.
He got
a hat trick. He went in easy.
Kept alive by Wiener. He gloves it down. Wiener back across. Smith into the middle. Cummings, what
bad
a
save.
Stop.
Oh, they get one.
Get it.
On the rebound.
All right, there you see it. A Lawrence Tech win. They get here today. Didn't make it to the semifinals last year, but UM Dearborn did. Matthew LaForest was the star of the show that time around against Aquinas. He had a hat trick, including the game-winning goal, but we're focused on the present. Dearborn got up to speed a little bit with Rochester. Lawrence Tech, a little bit of a tougher game with Cleary. But who do you kind of think has the upper hand here coming right out of the gates? Who do you think might be more ready to go?
I think I'm kind of going to pull for Lawrence Tech, you know, in my heart. But I think on paper, University of Michigan is looking tougher. And I think that, like I said earlier about the spell where Lawrence Tech stepped on the gas and just poured it on, I think Dearborn's going to shut down any opportunity for them to get a huge momentum shift. And I just, you know, you look around and I just think that the University of Michigan Dearborn's just going to may have the competitive edge here. But out of heart, I think Lawrence Tech, you know, is going to fight their way, you know, as far as they can and try to be their first effort, just like we saw earlier in the game with Concordia, having two, you know, totally different teams going into tomorrow's, you know, final game. And let's see what they do. Yeah. Like we saw earlier, I mean, who knows what they're going to bring today. So,
yeah, it'll be interesting to see how it goes. One of the strengths of this Dearborn team is their star power at the top. Brendan West, the WAC Player of the Year. Bailey Bird, he is the newcomer of the year and a first-team all-conference selection. Joey Cullinan, second-team all-conference. Mikhail Kudenko falls short of either of those honors, but he's right up there as well. But we talked about it yesterday. Then there's a large drop-off in the points. From Kudenko down to Makarchuk, their fifth leading scorer, it's 15 points. It is not that same situation for Lawrence Tech. Yes, Thiemo I leads the team by, you know, probably more than 6 points now, but it was 6 points coming into the weekend. After that, it's a lot more of a deep team, and so we'll see if that start for Lawrence Tech, they might, for Dearborn, they might start hot, but they might have to contend with the depth here that Lawrence Tech has, and Dearborn, at least on the score sheet, doesn't have as much of that.
Yeah, I think they're going to try to shut down Thiemo because he had a great game, he had a great game last night, so yeah, I mean, that's your goal. But yeah, I think the rest of the team today might step up and fill in those spots, you know, where there's been some holes. But yeah, that's what's great about tournament time. It's just different than regular season. You know, like you're talking about the matchups and stuff, you know, we see teams that just, you know, lose all season long, but come down to the wire here, it's a whole different game. You got experience against them, you know, you look at your matchups and try something, you know, extraordinary, and hopefully we get to witness that and see just one fine game here this evening.
Yeah, it should be great. High expectations for this one. Since we brought up the all-conference stuff, we'll go ahead and flash these awards to you. These were awarded after the first game. There you see the first team all-conference. Like I said, it's Weston Bird, Max Hartwell, also a member of that team. Spencer Kroll for Lawrence Tech, he's the first team all-conference goalie. We'll see him today. And Cole Barney, Cam Chabot, rounding it out as representatives of Indiana Tech. We'll take a look at the second all-conference team as well. Another couple of players we'll see today. Joey Cullinan from Dearborn, Thiemo I from Lawrence Tech, Josh Makarchuk as well, and Matej Krasny, Alex Potter, the representatives from Indiana Tech. And maybe to some a bit of a surprise selection, but as someone who stood here and watched a lot of games, I think very deserving of this honor of being the second team all-conference goaltender is Anthony Carlier from Rochester. Bryce, you've been here for all three games we've done for Rochester. I feel like you could probably have some words on Carlier.
Oh, Carlier is just incredible to watch. Fast reaction, puts himself where he needs to be. He's not afraid of playing the screen. I mean, he is just calm. Even the way he gloves the puck, it's just it's beautiful rhythm. And it's just it's tough sometimes when he's facing all those shots. It makes him better, but at times he does need relief. But yeah, he's going to be well missed there in Rochester. But the freshman goalie's starting to look pretty good. You know, I mean, in comparison, I mean, that's a tough, you know,
it's a
act
tough
to
spot
follow.
To fill.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
A tough job to hold on to. Carlier, not a ton of help in front of him this year, but that's a young team. We'll see what they can do moving forward. Carlier, very deserving of that little shout out there. And we'll see, like I said, the other all-conference goalie, Spencer Kroll, in this one. He is a part of the starting lineup. Eric Polzin is in net for the Wolverines. We'll get the rest of the starting lineups here in just a moment, and we'll turn it on over to the public address. And when it looks like they're about ready to go, and I think we're good enough that we're going to go ahead and do that now.
On
right. Definitely could not make out what the Dearborn one was for sure. So we'll just go ahead and recite that one to you. It's probably who'd you expect up front. It's Cullen and West and Bird. It's O'Connell and McCarchuk on the back end. And like we said, it is going to be Eric Poulsen manning the blue paint yet again for Dearborn. And we thought we might see something else, but this Dearborn team, very balanced in goal, and it looks like they might be riding Poulsen, all three of their goalies, Poulsen, Beals, and Pickles. All of them have goals against averages ranging from 2.51 to 2.88. Their save percentages are all between 0.911 and 0.92. Incredibly consistent and level goaltending out of the Wolverines, who are once again sporting those beauteous yellow jerseys.
Yeah, with both netminders on the bench working the doors, they're going to keep an eye on this and see if they need to give any advice down the line there, but we're about ready for puck drop here.
Here we go. Semi-final number two, day number two, teams taking the center ice, and it's puck drop, and away we go, and now we're off officially. Took him an extra second, but we're ready to go. It comes over to McCarchuk now for Dearborn as they start this one off with possession across the red line. McCarchuk will rim it around to the far side, stopped by the stick of Kuntz. That is Pele, and there's a penalty coming right away to UMD.
Yeah, that comes in at 16 seconds.
So a quick opportunity on the power play for Lawrence Tech, and it looks like they got the check from behind signal. Which
2 minutes?
Yeah. So here we go. Just 16 seconds in, as you said, and Joey Cullinan sits in the sin bin. And Dearborn has a penalty to kill off. Lawrence Tech will win the draw back to Jentz. Goes down the wall. That is to Hubenschmidt. O'Connell has it pinned. Three blue jerseys surrounding him. An all-timer on the jersey matchup today. One of the highlights of Indiana Tech going down, by the way, is if Dearborn advances, we get another day seeing those yellow jerseys.
I kind of like the blue at Lawrence Tech. A little better than their the blue and white ones last night. I kind of like that solid blue.
I like the blue. The only beef I have is they don't have nameplates.
Yeah, that's the toughie.
But that's a minor concern. We love the contrast with the colors we have going on here tonight. I wish we would do that more often.
Yeah, it's pretty vibrant.
Hartwell rims it all the way around, and it is stopped by Jentz. He starts to play back up ice. He finds Pele. Pele put into the wall by Hartwell. Emery back there. He hammers that one around. It is kept alive there at the point by Heyer. Sent down the ice, well gloved just in neutral by Rundle. He goes ahead and moves it on back. And this is Matavi, is what we were being told. Sources indicate.
Yeah, he's not alone without a nameplate.
Yes, but we do know how to say his name now. That's what I was told. So now yesterday, if we didn't have a nameplate, we'd really be in trouble. Here's Kudenko in the near corner, able to backhand it out. This one's going to make it almost all the way down. Only about 30 more seconds on the penalty to Cullinan. McCarchuk goes D to D for O'Connell, who sends it the length of the ice. Jentz is back there for the Blue Devils. That's a turnover as Bird is onto the scene. He has control. He'll bring it across the attacking line, dishes it out to West. West with the shot, and it's deflected up into the safety netting.
Well, they're handling pretty well on this penalty kill, so it's not hurting them too soon. I mean, if you want to get a penalty, get it early because, you know, no one's settled. But if the other team's ready to go, that's going to be tough. But this is good ice. That's the beauty of it when you're fresh on that nice, clean ice. But as time goes on, eek.
We'll see what we get here. Still 13 more seconds for Lawrence Tech, but a defensive zone draw. Bailey Bird on the faceoff tries to go right around his man. That looks like I. And it is controlled now by Sample. He lifts it all the way down. It bounces past Pille, and now McCarchuk gives chase. And we're going to get icing called here. It'll come all the way back down as Lawrence Tech has iced it on the power play, albeit with just 2 seconds left. That should kill it for the Wolverines.
Yeah, they showed their hand on that stretch because Pille had to sit there and wait on it. And did the bouncing Betty, and into the zone it went, so he couldn't pick it up solidly. And see what they do off this face.
Kudenko to the draw. Demo eyes his opposite. It's one back to the point for O'Connell. He sends it down low to Matthews. Matthews trying to feed out in front. Hammered around by, that is I. and comes down, or pulls and will leave it. McCarchuk picks up, starts to skate it ahead. Working his way across the red line. It's into the Lawrence Tech end. And here you go with Kudenko. Kudenko with the backhand to Matthews. He sends it off of Kroll. Sample into the near side corner. Almost turns it over to Petterle. It comes up and it's off of the wall past Hubenschmidt all the way down, and it will be icing. Lawrence Tech, a couple of icings here in the early going.
Yeah, they had to save the day there and just get rid of it a couple times. I mean, that one was clear as the other one was a strategy that failed. But, yeah, I mean, so they were – Dearborn was playing really tough there, and it looked like a couple times that Lawrence Tech should have picked the puck up, and instead chances for picking up loose pucks were done by Dearborn.
Off the draw, it comes to the near side corner. That is Bland, who has it pinned there. Comes out to Hartwell. Hartwell with the shot. It's blocked. Now in the skate of Cesarini. Kapari picks it up for the Wolverines. Emery retreats to Hartwell. Hartwell off the skates of Kapari. Potter trying to navigate it in. Still trying to work it in deep. Kapari is there again as well. And bringing it up the ice is McGowan. McGowan backhands it towards the goal, pulls in, will direct it to the corner. O'Connell is double-teamed, and Cesarini had it for a second. Now McGowan into the corner. He's bodied off the play by O'Connell. Kapari getting involved with Cesarini. Two-on-two battle down in the far corner. Puck comes free, and McCarchuk will pick it up. Tries to find the outlet through the middle of the ice, and he does off of Bigelow, but it's turned right back in by Sample. Rimmed hard all the way around, and arriving there is number 16, Bradley Scott. Heads up for West. He's lit up.
What a good hit there put on by Sample.
Brendan West kind of caught looking the wrong way there. Sample steps up on him, and West down to the ice. Now here come the Wolverines reattacking. It's Hartwell. Takes the shot. It is blocked. Loose out high. Bird can't get to it in time. It's poked out of the zone past him by Hickson. Sensali gets it off of Hartwell, and it goes in deep. Back there now is Matavi. Bird can't glove it down, and it goes all the way down, and it will be icing yet again on Lawrence Tech.
Well, we saw this before out of most of the teams, still sizing each other up, trying to figure out how to get something going. We see a lot of zeros, but boy, I don't want to see an unbalance like we did earlier, and especially against Tech that we saw. But it looks like Dearborn is controlling.
McCarchuk with the shot goes wide, probably more of a just send it down low attempt than anything. Rundle can't chip it out past O'Connell. Petterle and Sample collide. Petterle still over to the wall. Kudenko comes in trying to help out and has control of it. Kudenko will drop it for O'Connell. Down into the corner. Petterle out to the corner for Kudenko. O'Connell down to the half wall. Kudenko, his shot goes wide. McCarchuk sends it towards the goal. It goes wide again, and the net has come off.
Yeah, you can see McCarchuk was just tasting that. He comes squeezing in a little bit, and that puck was sitting there open, but just out of reach. He would have got one, but good job for Kroll to stay alert. So we'll see if this theory we heard earlier, once these nets come off, they'll come off all day. So it's rare it's down here, but it's usually the other end. But
yeah, well, if it happens this early that they start coming off all the time, that could make for a long rest of the evening. We'll hope for the best, though. Now bringing the puck up ice is Priest
alone.
Priest sends the shot wide, but it goes all the way back out, and his team controlled it well for a second. Now it's sent across for Bigelow. Jens is over there, but Kuntz is the one that plays it. Demo I dodges the hit there. It's either him or Pille. This is Pille, as that is onside. But icing, I think, is what we're going to end up calling on this.
Yeah, I think they're talking about it right now. And if it's any question, they're going to face off center, but they're talking about
I think it
looks
offside.
Like, is what they're he's indicating.
Yeah, I mean, it was close. It was close. He might have been.
Oh, they're going to call icing then.
All right. So there you go.
I guess that's the better explanation when it's close for an offside.
Well, Lawrence Tech is going to change their guys. So maybe it's not icing.
Huh.
Oh, but I mean, if it's offside, but that's where the pass is coming from, that would track. But that would be quite the interesting location for offsides face off. That might be a first for me.
Yeah. I mean, it's not like they were just,
Looks like they're good to go, and it's calling into the face off, and it is higher to the face off.
Ooh.
Now into the near corner. Up the wall, West sends it back down. Here's Bird. Bird with the shot, and it goes high. West picks it up, skating along the blue line, feeds it to Bird. Bird with the backhand. Ooh. It's still loose there, and
cover.
Cole is able to find it.
Boy, team effort there. Wow, Priest was staying really tight with Bird there and trying to keep something when he got burnt. When he fell, he still played him, hauled the stick in the gut, and doing anything they can to stop between Bird and West's effort here.
Okay. They're going to the other side. Dearborn's sending a lot of guys out to the other side of the faceoff. All right, so it'll be to the left of Kroll. Cullinan is in there, and so is Heyer. Hemp steps up, and he took the stick away from Kroll, but it's going to be okay. He's able to recover it. Makarchuk settles down the puck, and Cullinan will skate into it and pick it up. Cullinan across the line, takes the shot. It's blockered up by Kroll, and it does stay in play. Well, it goes out of play, excuse me.
Wow. I thought he was shifting wrong there on that reach, but had a three-man D coming back to help out too.
Blake Petterly and Themo I will do battle in the dot. And it's won by I, coming off of the hat trick yesterday against the Cougars. Kudenko keeps that one in, taps it down with the stick, but is eventually forced to retreat. Hartwell gets to the blue line and cross corner sends it. Over there is Petterly and Kudenko. Those guys getting roughed up by a Lawrence Tech player. And Pille sweeps it over to Hubenschmidt. Hubenschmidt's shot is redirected away by Polzin. Comes out into the corner. I with the shot and kicked away by Polzin. Hartwell, he's got his stick tied up. Over the far side, now it's I. Sent over to Hartwell, and he's in his own zone. Going to set up a little bit of a breakout here. Finds Emery in the corner, who will give it right back to him. And stretched up ice for Matthews. It gets past him, whips it over to Kudenko, and played away by Magdish. Makarchuk. Hard rim around. It does get out. Bigelow has it on his stick. 3-on-2 for Dearborn until Matthews peels off, and it's gloved by Kroll. He will hang on.
Pretty interesting. Lawrence Tech's electing two guys to attack behind the net there, and it's not Burnham yet, but, boy, I thought right there was going to be a chance with that odd man rush there.
That draw again, won by the Blue Devils. Bigelow trying to work it to Kapari. Kapari now to the near side corner. He's pushed into the wall. Has a man on him. That is Matavi. Kapari is there still. Comes up the wall. Makarchuk keeps at the point, whips it on goal. It's sticked away by Kroll. To the far side, Magdish. Through the skates of O'Connell, McGowan goes tumbling to the ice.
Offside
is signaled for, and then it is called.
Yeah, he was like, can I get a trip? No, well, you were offsides first. All right, looks like full changes here.
Face off right in front of the Dearborn bench. It's Cullinan, Bird, and West out there, the big line for the Wolverines. Off the draw, Hem will dump it in. Hartwell stops up behind his goal. Rundle right in front of Polzin. Hartwell drops it off to Emery. Cullinan now trying to find West. Across into the offensive zone, though. Bird trying to fight this one from Sample. Sample doing some good work down there for the Blue Devils. Now Hem looking to move it up the ice. It gets past Emery. Will go down. Icing is signaled for, but it won't make it. Hartwell, plenty of open ice in front of him. Starts to play ahead for the team in the yellow. He spun out. That is a penalty, and that is going to be on Ian Koontz.
Yeah, Koontz just wanted to size him up, but he just wrapped him up, spun him out, and took him down. So easy call. And he's not happy at himself for that. But, yeah, another three-man D coming back, and then they gave up personnel off that effort.
So now it's the first power play attempt for UM Dearborn. Don't remember what exactly they did on the power play yesterday. Don't think they really got a lot of opportunities. Pretty low penalty game, I think. Here's O'Connell. He goes down to Petterly. Petterly still with the handle on it. Now will go to the left point for Makarchuk. Kudenko whips it across to O'Connell. O'Connell with the wrist shot, and it goes wide. Might have gotten a piece of Kroll. Makarchuk down to Kudenko, trying to walk through the high slot. Kudenko will circle back up towards the blue line. Now Makarchuk had it in his skates, able to dodge the pressure for now. He goes hard into the wall, and that's going to allow, just under the stick of him as Pille was trying to send him on a potential breakaway.
Yeah, Hem tried to pass that up with his throat. He got that just about in the neck area to spoil that effort. So good job by them to get it at least down into the attacking zone on a penalty kill.
Faceoff down to the left of Polzin. It's Cullinan and Heyer, and it's won by Heyer just straight into the glove of Polzin, and so they will do it again. They didn't even have to stop the music.
Yeah, it gives him rhythm on the faceoff.
Still 1:23 on the power play for Dearborn. Sent back in by Lawrence Tech, and Bird will collect it at the far corner and let Emery start moving it ahead. Drops it back for Bird. The newcomer of the year in the WAC. Brings it across the line, trying to get it back to Cullinan, but it's played out. That one forced away by Brendan Priest. Priest, the Champions of Character nominee for Lawrence Tech. And Joey Cullinan, I believe, had that honor for UMD. Sample rims it around. It gets off of a stanchion and is going to go just wide of the goal, but Polzin will play it anyways. He shoots it right up the ice to Cullinan. He touches it back to West, who dodges one that time. Now here comes West, cutting back in the middle. It's off his stick. Cullinan right there. Kroll trying to find it.
For it.
No whistle yet. It's still loose. It's behind the goal. Cullinan, that's West actually in the corner with it. To the left point, Makarchuk works it across to Bird. Bird fans on the pass, and that is going to be sent down by Gents with about 14 seconds.
He
goes right up to West. Here you go with West. He's got help. He drops it off to Bigelow. Bigelow with the shot, and it's right into the chest.
Bigelow went a little.
Spencer Kroll.
He went a little soon there. I mean, he was getting reinforcements there. Lawrence Tech was still on a change. All calls by Polzin firing it up the ice, keeping the play alive. Yeah, Bigelow, I think, went a little early, and Kroll was ready. Here we go, the net.
Yeah, there we go. They're re-examining the net. It looks like it's okay. That one must have just been a minor problem.
Yeah.
But here we go. So 8 more seconds, and then stepping out of the box will be Koontz, and we'll be back to 5-on-5. Into the corner, Petterly out for Kudenko. Kudenko cutting across, heads it, and takes the shot and scores!
Oh, it was technically even strength because the clock had cleared, but the box hasn't. Wow.
So it's UMD that is on the board first. Like you said, it's just barely an even strength goal. And Kudenko, after having a couple of them yesterday, he has another at least today. As Dearborn fighting to make it back to the WAC championship. Only they are one of only two teams to have claimed a WAC tournament championship in the conference's now 7-year history. Dearborn has two, Indiana Tech the other four. We'll have a new champion for the first time in 2 years. Regardless, will we have an entirely new champion in either Lawrence Tech or Concordia? We'll have to find out tomorrow at 1 o'clock. Dearborn hoping that they can stop that new coronation from happening. And they are leading this one 1-0, bringing it back up the ice. Bigelow has it blocked, and it goes into the Lawrence Tech bench.
Yeah, Kuntz played that one. He was going to look like he was going to play stick or body up because he feels he cost his team one. So no harm, no foul. Face off just outside of their defensive zone.
It'll be Cullen into the draw and Hickson for the Blue Devils. Both teams wearing some nice script jerseys across the front, baseball style. It is spring training. Here we go. It is Hartwell. He'll just take this one all the way back and stop up behind his own goal. Under a little bit of pressure from Hickson, he dishes it over to Emery. It's behind Cullinan, the intended target. Here's Sample. It's off of West. That would have been potentially offside. And now Hickson gets it ahead for Rundle. Rundle still hanging on. One-timer by Hickson goes wide. Bird chips it out past him. Now here's Sample along the red line. Sends it right back in. Polzin will leave it for Hartwell. Hartwell back into the corner again for Emery. Comes across. That one, it is too far in front of Cullinan. Trickles on goal, and Kroll will play it into the corner. Cullinan along the far half wall. He just cycles it down. Played up off the glass, heads and up. That one is going to be well out of play. And heads up on the Dearborn bench.
Yeah, wakes up the coaching staff.
Still 7:56 here in the first period, under the halfway mark.
Yeah, it was fun to watch. Priest playing West very tight, so keep an eye on that throughout this game when those two are opposing forces on the ice.
Faceoff is controlled by Kuntz. Up the wall, O'Connell trying to keep it. Petterle does.
Wow.
And now Gents with control. He sends it right into still his teammate. Kept. It's still kept in there by Petterle. It's into the corner now. He gives a bump from Gents, and we're going to get a penalty here on
an interference
Gents.
From the bump?
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's how they're going to call it, I guess.
Wow, I thought that was a side-to-side type. Huh.
Also, now if you're going to establish that, that's how you're going to have to call it.
So
we'll see if that's going to be something that comes into play.
That's just interesting. As a defenseman, it's tough to.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know what? It is kind of interference there. Tried to bump him as they were going both for the puck. So, probably something more often than not that gets let go, especially in a playoff situation. But calling it by the book, and that is what the book is for. Petterle over there. Kudenko trying to pin it along the wall for a second. O'Connell able to keep this one, and Kudenko picks it up. Kudenko stops up. He sends it across to O'Connell. Takes a shot. It's blocked.
Second
Another
effort.
Try. It's blocked again. Still loose out in front, though, for a second. Who's got the puck down there? It's Matthews.
And a high.
Picked up now by Kudenko. He's got his stick tied up, loses control of the puck. Makarchuk is able to keep it in. Makarchuk makes a nice move. Takes a shot. It's blocked. Now into the slot. Can they play it out? Yes, they can.
Just barely
was higher, being able to get it out. Took a little too long to kind of settle that one down and fire it.
Yeah, O'Connell.
Almost cost him.
Yeah, O'Connell with a good feet there. Kept the puck there, at least in the neutral. Now they do what they want with it.
Cullinan through the skates of Bird, gets it over to West. West still hanging on with some sticks in his face. Now down to Cullinan. Bounces out in front. Bird trying, but can't get it and score.
Good
sent player. All the way down by Lawrence Tech with 43 seconds still to go on the man advantage. Hartwell will move it ahead, and he sends it over to Emery. Emery with the hard rim around to Cullinan. Cullinan Lost it for a second. Now he sends it down low. West trying to kick it towards Bird. DDD for Emery now at the right point. Cullen in high slot takes the shot. It goes wide. Bird trying to get the rebound. It's still back there, but Bird has control. Cullen taken down. He's laying across the ice.
Yeah, no
calls. Over to Bird in the left circle. Yeah, no call. Hartwell over to Emery. He fires that one. It goes into the corner. West trying to get control back for the Wolverines. Now here comes Hem for Lawrence Tech. Back to even strength. That one caught Polson maybe ever so slightly, but it goes wide. Bird going to have to skate back into the corner of this one. He's got Hubenschmidt with him. Bird down to the ice. That is boarding, and now we are going to get another penalty as going into the wall. That looks like Emery, and it's going to be Gents going right back.
Yep, he's heading back in there. He came out with a head of steam, and it worked for him, but, yeah, he's going to get more energy built up as he'll take another break.
Checking from behind, it looks like. Referees this weekend haven't been great about clearly signaling what the penalties are.
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest.
We should have gave him our plug, but yeah.
Yeah. Should have had a word with him earlier. It's all good, though. Here we go. So it's another penalty power play for Dearborn. This is their third, and they are 0-2 technically, but they are effectively at least have one. As that goal.
Oh, here we go.
Here's a breakaway attempt for
Heyer. Here comes
a trip. Shorthanded. Oh! That is going to be a penalty shot.
Yeah, that's going to be. Let's see.
It is. So,
yeah, that's
how
definitely.
About this?
And see, we saw earlier in the Tech game that Dugan came down and played stick on a dive, and that was incredible. No penalty. And this one, you can see the stick just slowly reaching out for the foot. Still, I mean, you got confidence, your goaltender. I'd rather take a penalty shot than try to stare down 2 minutes.
Yeah, we'll see what we get here. And so after this, then it'll still be a power play as well for Dearborn in theory.
Mm-hmm.
Now we'll see what we get. It is going to be Blake Heyer. Heyer versus Polson. One-on-one. Heyer trying to tie this game up. Everyone is set, and we get the whistle. Here we go. Heyer takes it up and ranges over to his left, coming in with speed. Heyer with the shot. It's off the post.
Wow, he clanked the iron there.
We'll take another look at that one. Heyer picks it up, coming in hot, just was going to rip it. And he sends it off the iron.
Yeah, but now they saw where they can try to take advantage and do that in real time. With four teammates with you, you might be able to pull it off.
So here we go. It's a big stand for Eric Polson in net. 1:43 still on a power play for Dearborn. So that is one of the things that we still have even after the penalty shot. And it was a great defensive play by Heyer to even send himself on that shorthanded breakaway.
Mm-hmm.
Emery trying to work it in deep, but Sample says no to that, and he sends it all the way down himself. Under 90 seconds on the power play for Dearborn. It comes to Hartwell, and he'll just shake off eye and hang out behind the Dearborn goal here for a second. Pille at least giving token pressure, and now Hartwell will start moving ahead. Hartwell, he'll gain the line and dump it down low. Kroll will leave it. Sample will rim it, and it does come out to the neutral zone. Emery back for Makarchuk. Makarchuk goes down
good
to the
play.
Ice.
All he did was reach in on that. He took the hit there, but he did not cause that stumble there. So
looking to go to the point for Makarchuk, but Makarchuk wasn't in the zone, so Dearborn has to recalibrate. They come all the way back, and now 35 more seconds. The man advantage, here's Cullinan. Cullinan down the left side, has to stop up, waits for some reinforcements, and he'll find it at the left point with Makarchuk. Sent across to O'Connell, now in the corner for Bird. Bird up to O'Connell, D-to-D to Makarchuk. Makarchuk trying to feed in the middle for Cullinan. It's a turnover, now O'Connell able to keep it though. West, along the goal line, tries a bad angle, shot. Comes out to O'Connell, he goes to the left point, Makarchuk. Looking to go back across for Bird. It's into the corner. Bird is pinned there by Matavi. As time expires on the power play, we'll see if Dearborn can do it again right after, though. Makarchuk with a shot.
Ooh,
and almost scream. Had it, but it's deflected into the corner. That is sent down, and it's going to go just wide. Yeah. And so back to even strength, it will be icing.
Yeah, tired line by Lawrence Tech, but you know what? That's a strong line, so they're not too bad right here. But, yeah, penalty did clear. So at least they have the 5 men they need to thwart off the attacking Dearborn chances here.
Petterly and higher to the faceoff. It's won by Lawrence Tech. McGowan brings it up the ice, and Magdish is able to get it in deep.
Oh,
almost a little miscue there for Dearborn, but they're okay for right now. Two-on-two battle in the near side corner. Hartwell with the release over to Emery. Emery has Matthews trying to streak up the ice, but Jentz has that under control. And then now Lawrence Tech can come back up the ice, but that is going to be, it's waved off. They waved it off. They'll say it got tipped or was through the six and they could have touched it. Rimmed up the near wall, but it's kept alive. Cesarini over for the shot that goes wide. That one coming from Bland. Cesarini picks up again. Jentz over to the near point for French. French with a shot towards the net is blocked by Emery. Bouncing puck, Matthews trying to collect it. Two-on-two battle again. Hartwell has it for Dearborn, and he backhands it up to the blue line, but not out. It's kept by Jentz.
It's almost a hand pass.
That time it does come out, but French will send it right back in. Offside play. They'll have to tag up, but Lawrence Tech wants a full change anyways. So does Dearborn. Down to under the 2 minute warning here in the first period. It is still a 1-0 lead as Potter redirects that one down and it gets in deep. Matavi behind the Lawrence Tech net. They'll send it into the corner and now up ice. We are not going to get a penalty on that one, but they're appealing for it. Near side Pille, how to get past him. Potter chips it out past Magdish. And it's sent back cross corner by Matavi. Under some pressure was O'Connell. Makarchuk can't poke it out. Back into the corner for Thimo Ai. Comes out to the point. Sample with the shot. It's redirected.
Wow.
Gloved down. It was still there. Had a potential chance, but it doesn't work out for Lawrence Tech.
Yeah, O'Connell might have been a part of almost putting it in.
Hem works into his own end and has control of it. It's off of the skate of Potter, but it's gloved by Hartwell. He goes D to D over to Makarchuk. Makarchuk now for Kolonen. Brought across and dumped in. Played by Kroll. He rims it around into the corner where Kolonen and Bird are both there. Bird is the one who was trying to pick it up there, and now it is coming out. And Bird is going to regroup it in neutral. Hartwell across the line, hammers it around. 35 more seconds here of this period. West picks it up going into the corner. He's stifled on that opportunity, and Hem dumps it down.
What a backspin that had. Otherwise, that was heading for icing.
Yeah, that was a fortunate break for Hartwell, and now coming out around the back of the goal. He's starting to build ahead of steam here. Hartwell down in the left circle, wrapping around. He's got the puck still, looking for a centering option. Doesn't have one at the moment, and West looking, the Lawrence Tech fans looking for tripping there on Brendan West. Might have grounds for it.
Yeah, but he stuck his foot out. And
I mean, the way they've called it so far, that's kind of what I would tend to lean towards Lawrence Tech. The way that they've called it so far, that probably should have been a penalty.
Yeah.
But all right, that will do it for the first period. Through 20 minutes, it's a 1-0 lead for UMD. We'll go ahead and throw it to a full highlight package from day number one of the WAC tournament. When we come back, it'll be the intermission report. The WAC Men's Ice Hockey Tournament brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. Ice to Bird. Bird too far in front of Kolonen. Icing is going to be waved off here. Kolonen in on the scene first with the size advantage. West over looking for Bird. Didn't take the pass. Now down low. Kolonen trying to jam at the side of the goal.
Shot.
West in front. Takes a shot and scores.
Yeah. He picked up that loose there.
2-D for Hartwell. Nice find across the seam looking for Kudenko. Kept in by O'Connell. And loose out in front for a second. Matthews, and he scores.
Yeah. Carly could not hold on, and it's a second.
In the corner, he's got two guys on him. comes out to the point for McCarchuk. McCarchuk looking to go back door, and that is a goal. They will count it.
Yeah, Carlier stretched out.
He's pressured by Potter. Battle ensues. Bird is in there. Saville comes away with it, though. And sticking with it, though, is Bird. Colonen in there as well. Here's Colonen. Stick handles and shoots and scores.
Him. They could not get a hold of it.
Chance pulls in. Wow. Don't think it got to him. Right out in front there. That was Conmo. Up ice for Matthews. Plays it into the open room for Kudanko, who skates into it. Stops up. Dodges the check. Goes parallel over to Hartwell. Hartwell. Nice find to Matthews. Oh. But a great save by Carlier.
Carlier looked like he was going to give that up.
Skating up ice. Nice pass over to Banks. Zalewski. He's been a tremendous player today for this Rochester team. Here's Banks trying to go right out in front. Nobody home.
Yeah, Zalewski's digging in the ice, man. He's looking good. He's going to get a shot off
here.
Here
you go. Takes a shot and he scores!
Yeah, we called him out. He's been waiting for
well. Finds Colonen. Colonen, backhander. Carlier with the stop.
Wow.
Colonen to Bird. Fans on the shot. It slid right underneath. Saville up ice the other direction. Saville knifing through a couple. Nice moves there. But Polson able to track it the whole way and eventually get the cover. Get to it off the wall and cycle it for West. West into the slot. He'll drop it for Bird. Nice play across to West. Goes high and scores.
Yeah, that was signature. We saw that on the first effort of the
across the line. Surveying, feeding to Zalewski.
Oh.
And he'll make a nice pass over to Matthews, but Matthews is in the different colored jersey. Matthews on the attack now. Goes out wide. Feeding across. Perley hangs on and feeding and getting a goal.
That
from
one.
Kudanko.
Carly was everywhere on that. He thought
circling around, still with it. Hartwell. We now go over to McCarchuk. McCarchuk with some traffic. It's loose right out in front. Can they find it? It's still batting around out there. Comes out to West Hill Hammer, and that one is stepped out. Been able to make the save on that one. Coming back up ice is Denartai. Denartai. Still with control. Cutting across slot with the shot. And scores!
Wow, Stewart followed through there. Look,
gets past Rosema and out. Here's Rydell. He'll lead the charge ahead for the Cardinals. Rydell with the shot. It's
rolls through. But the whistle was blown.
Oh, man. That was a quick one from Allman. Looking for the pass to Ettinger. Long near wall. Big hit alert.
Yeah.
And we play on. It's stopped by Allman. Water bottle now on the ice behind the goal, I think. But it's sent up,
here
you go. Here's Denartai on a breakaway. Denartai on his lonesome. Slides it through the five hole, but stopped.
Yeah, that's a good play. I love trying to score like
poke it back. And now with control of it is Blau. Cross ice. Bienick, here you go. Opportunity for Kyle Hebner. Has it, passes it, and it's stopped by Allman.
Allman came over.
Who's bodied off of it. Now McCaddy with control. Long pass ahead for Rumpke. Rumpke has one man to beat. Dylan Rumpke on his lonesome. Changes it up, and it's still up and over the goal. A great save there. Still a battle going on along the wall here. Comes out to Temple. Temple looking across. Ice, nice find, and it goes just wide. And the net comes off, but that might have been the best around. Well, backhand it to the point. Ronbeck gets past him. He's got Hoon on him, but he's able to get rid of it before it becomes an issue. Keppel to Twombly. Now here's Francois. Francois shakes a defender. Tries to send it, and he scores!
He's just going for the ride there.
Here we go. It's a two-on-one if they hurry for Aquinas. Trying to get it across to Phillips and just that is a decent-sized collision. Now we get a coming together of players as well.
Oh, he's trying to break a stick. He's mad. It's a right out.
Delivered it to, that looks like Kuhn, who got a check from Hebner pinching in. Comes out to Blau. Blau in the middle. Bienick, a shot there.
It's
ripped.
Oh, it's
bounced back. Still there.
Again.
Bienick, he scores.
Wow, there had to work for that. That puck came in and out, in and out.
Coming right back, though, is Aquinas. It's Look. Hebner off the glass and out. Quinn Bienick now has no help. He's a man on his lonesome, and he's shut down by Johnson.
No,
does a great job. Here we go. Has Tails with him. Goes over to Tails. And it stopped.
Wow.
That one might have just missed completely. Out. And Concordia will come right back at it. Rombach sends it cross corner. and sent all the way down on goal by McCaddy.
Nice feed down there. Oh, look.
Here you go. It's Rumpke.
Oh, he scores! Wow, so the clear or stretch pass, whatever you want to call it.
And that faceoff is going to be controlled by the Saints. They'll take their time getting this one set up. It is Whaling. He goes across to Rumpke. Rumpke up ice, cutting towards the net, now circling around behind, passes out in front, it was there, and now Sikora able to get the cover.
Now Blau's kind of shoving.
No, by the Saints. Blau trying to keep it, Bienik a shot towards the goal, now this is Quinn with it on his stick, he's fighting for control, he's got Prukitski trying to take away from him, Kyle Hebner, out to Tyler Bienik, he's stopped by Ullman.
Wow.
For here's Rumpke, trying to shake Twombly off of him, goes out to the point for look. It's intercepted by Twombly, and now here come the Cardinals. Into the middle lane for Keppel. Onside play, Keppel, left side, takes the shot, scores! Concordia is moving on!
Wow.
Gardner off the wall, sends it on goal. It is deflected wide by Bandog getting the start tonight. Comes back to Gardner again, shot off the crossbar.
What a shot.
And that one stays. Has a win over Indiana Tech, as does UMD. They are the only two conference teams who have beaten the Warriors, who have lost three games all season. Here is Wes Smith through neutral. Dodging through still. In pursuit, Wes Smith with the shot and draws a penalty to boot. Cougars are able to get it here. It comes out to the point for Wiener. He walks along the line and sends it down to Gledhow. Gledhow for Wiener. Poked away. Here we go. Shorthanded opportunity for Lawrence Tech. Fakes and stopped by Krasovsky.
Both goalies looking good.
And the Lawrence Tech goal now. Back to even strength. All that penalty time cleared off. Directed towards the goal. Here's a shot from Thomas right there.
Wow.
They score.
Oh, man. They were just hanging on to the puck.
Here. Stops up. Gives over to Gents. Over to Saccarini. Hem steps into one off the iron.
Rings the pipes there.
Oh, that is actually Wiener. Here is Eakes. Eakes. Around one. Had it poked away. Gives it to Rundle. Rundle is lit up. Herhoff down to Thomas, and now it comes out. Here, picking this one up and gaining some speed. Here, wrap around, feeding out in front.
Wow, coming in. Just going into the slot, blunt.
And Wafer has a player still draped all over him. Right out in front.
Goal.
And they score. Thiemel Eye again.
Wow.
Sent back down low, McBeth to the near wall. It's a bouncer, it comes off. Here's a chance for Hemi, a backhand rebound in front, and they score.
Just got Hemi.
All the way down, Gledhow has Sample all over him. Heads up for Gledhow. He and Sample tangle up, and now we're going to get a penalty. That is going to be on Gledhow.
Yeah, no frustration here. He's got a broken stick, and now he's getting a second penalty.
And I think the official might have been in the line of fire on. Very good. The microphone, I don't think, is very good.
Well, I think one of them will be the unsportsman.
Here with the shot, and he scores.
Yeah. Unopposed.
If it was one or two, that's one thing, but I feel like there are like five that are questionable. So. Looking for another one. They almost get it, and they do.
Wow. So this one, boy, I'll tell you, what a game.
All right.
This is 2 minutes, so.
11-12, still to go in this one. Eye in pursuit. He wants another one. Thiemel Eye, does he get it? Yes,
he
does.
He got a hat trick. He went in easy.
Kept alive by Wiener. He gloves it down. Wiener back across. Smith into the middle. Cummings, what
a save.
Oh,
they get one.
They get it.
On the rebound.
Welcome back inside the Sport One Parkview Ice House. First intermission here between Dearborn and Lawrence Tech. And Bryce, pretty evenly matched period for the most part, but it's Dearborn that has the lead through 20 minutes.
Yeah, so two out-of-town teams have a decidedly out-of-town player, the only one who put something in the net be Mikhail Kudenko out of St. Petersburg, Russia. So come a long way to get a goal, so he is the star right now. And let's see what Lawrence Tech can do, if they can answer.
Yeah, it should be interesting. Lawrence Tech, we talked about, they kind of have more of the depth than Dearborn does. We'll see if that starts to play a bit more of a factor going later into this game. Both teams obviously did play yesterday. And Dearborn, kind of later in that Rochester game, you could tell they were trying to not put that top line of Cullinan, Bird, and West out there, trying to save those guys. But that just puts more pressure on the guys that they did have. Lawrence Tech kind of just ran them all the whole game, of course, because it only really opened up in the third period. What do you think Lawrence Tech kind of needs to do to try and get themselves back into this one? They've kind of gotten into a little bit of penalty trouble, so I'd have to imagine that's a good starting point.
Yeah, they've got to stay out of the box and just be consistent. But, you know, if they've learned anything from the game we called earlier, you know, they need to just keep going and keep trying to play and do like they did, like Concordia did against Indiana Tech. So, you know, you got a favorite team out there that's just not producing. Michigan is producing, but only one goal so far. West is being really tied up by Priest out there. Everybody's picking their guy, and they're staying with him no matter where. I watched Priest go both ends of the ice with West no matter where he went. So he's got a shadow on him, so we'll see. He'll break free at some point, I guarantee that. But if that's the strategy Lawrence Tech's doing, it's working, but they've got to start getting a little bit of offense where they break free. And because Michigan is giving them room to do that, it's just they're not capitalizing yet.
Yeah, for sure. You can shut West down all you want, but at some point he's probably going to break through and you need to find some goals of your own. With that said, we'll go ahead and step aside again. When we come back, it'll be time for the third period. You're watching the WAC Men's Ice Hockey Tournament brought to you by SummitCitySports.com.
Want to know the difference between dreaming and doing? Yeah, pretty much everything. Visit Indiana Tech and see what it's like to be a warrior. Want to know what it means to be a warrior? Yeah, pretty much everything. Visit Indiana Tech and walk a mile in a warrior's shoes.
Welcome to the Summit City, home to the 260's dedicated high school athletes and fans. Each victory and celebration captured by our camera. Treasure the highlights from the Summit Athletic Conference this season or complete games live or on demand. After all, nobody's more proud to call Fort Wayne home than SummitCitySports.com.
You want to know what's possible at Indiana Tech? Yeah, pretty much everything. Visit Indiana Tech and see what it's like to be a warrior.
Welcome back. Second period about ready to get underway here. In that first period, just the one goal for Dearborn. That was Mikhail Kudenko, 9:16 left, so right around the halfway mark when that one happened. And three penalties to Lawrence Tech compared to just one for Dearborn. Cullinan with the penalty for Dearborn, and then Kuntz and a pair of them to James Jens in fairly quick succession.
Well, we're ready for it. Let's see what they can do here and see which team wants to come out tough.
Here we go. Critical period. This was a golf tournament. We'd call it moving day. And here we go, right back to it. O'Connell as Dearborn hoping that they can make this a two-goal lead. Lawrence Tech obviously hoping to tie it up. West, a little slow to get up, but looks like he's going to be all right. This is Makarchuk. He takes a shot. It is stopped by Kroll. Into the corner, Makarchuk bodies a man up. Now Hem lost control, gets it right back, or trying to, has his stick lifted. Makarchuk, Cullinan now right along the goal line to Bird. That one might have gotten broken up before it even got to Bird. O'Connell down low into the corner, trying to get it for Cullinan. Makarchuk steps into this one and keeps it alive. Ranges over to the right. Has the shot. It goes wide. Might have gotten redirected with the way it was spinning around. Pulling in. We'll go over to West. West finally with a little bit of space here. Zornsek has done a tremendous job shutting him down to this point. But the nation's second leading scorer seems almost certain to break free at least at some point. And the WAC player of the year. Makarchuk afforded plenty of time. Sends it all the way down. And they are going to signal for icing and call it as we are a minute and 11 seconds in.
Yeah, I just saw some slow changes before that, so it won't hurt Dearborn any. So we'll see what they can do here. Let's see if Larsek take advantage of the position on the ice here.
I will take the face-off against Kolonen. It will be to the right of Polzin. One into the corner for Emery and play it out. Gents will control. Gets it up ice for Pille. Ooh. Pille with the shot. It is off the glove of Polzin into the corner. I sends it back across. Gents going over there now to the point. Sends it on goal. Polzin with the stick to the back of the rink. And Bird bumped off before he could clear it. And now it is sent out by Potter. Emery, potential hand pass. And it is as Bird hits that one before Lawrence Tech touches up.
Well, face off again in the zone and see if they can make something of this. 18-19 in the second. So early on, still no chances as of yet with Lawrence Tech on target at least.
Face off in the same spot as we had for the last one and being plenty patient before we drop it, making sure it's done right, and there now we go. But it comes out past Matavi. He'll send it on goal. Polzin is going to just go ahead and hang on to this one. And this time the faceoff will be to his left.
This might work better for Lawrence Tech here. See if the Blue Devils can capitalize on somewhere different here in the second early on.
Higher taking the faceoff. His backhand is to the wall. That one does work out only marginally better. And now Magdish will send it in.
Oh,
weird kind of bounce off of the wall there. And Emery has it poked
wow.
away by Haya.
Oh,
right out in front. And it's going to get out to the point. Matavi sends it back down low. Cesarini had his stick tied up. It's into the corner for Bland. And that's a weird angle shot. And they think it's in. Is it in?
Well, Lawrence,
no
the Blue
signal.
Devils are celebrating, but
there's no signal.
So the official did not come up right away to look. He just slid up there thinking, oh. I'm not sure why he did not just dig in and go look where that puck was, because that's an opportunity to – that's a dangerous opportunity, because if I were the Blue Devils, I wouldn't have gave up and cheered. I would have dove in there and just kept – and that's where people get hurt.
Yeah, so never really got an official signal, but obviously no goal. So that is a very weird situation. Like you're saying, he was very lax about getting in there.
Yeah, I've never seen an official just not go up there. I mean, hard to see. But then again, he didn't see any of the Blue Devils felt it was clear as can be. Now, we had that controversy in the last game where.
Yeah. Well, and what stands out to me is this defenseman out here on the left side for Dearborn, all the way at the point, he was one of the first ones with his arms up in the air celebrating. Now, I couldn't see it from my angle, but you never know. Down at ice level, it's a little bit different. But the referee in no rush, and it is deemed no goal. Back to it, though. Makarchuk, he's under some pressure here. Kudenko can't get it cleared, and it's sent back down low by Cesarini.
Bland,
unfortunate bounce. Talked about it yesterday. I think it was the Lawrence Tech game. Those boards don't close properly. It's a little bit staggered.
So here's a gap.
Now here you go with Heyer. Heyer works his way to the wall. Sends it on goal. Polzin able to handle that one. Now Kudenko will start it ahead for the Wolverines. Kudenko fires it right into the shin pads of Hem. Makarchuk now on the scene. Works his way out to the left. His stick is tied up. He's barreling through there. And now it goes into the corner for Hickson. Turned over. This is Matthews. He drops it over. There's a shot that goes wide from Makarchuk. Matthews to the point for Emery. Emery right over to Kroll and sent all the way down by Sample. That is going to be icing with 16:41 to play.
Yeah, that's a good give up there when your back's to it and it just hops too far in front of your netminder, launch it. you have no clue where you're at. That's what I always say. I said, I have no idea where I'm at. I don't know what's up or down or left or right. I don't want to turn it over and give them a chance in the slot.
So an offensive zone draw here for the Wolverines. Bird with the shot. It goes wide. Now over to the point. It goes back down into the corner. Sample takes it away. He rims it around. And Hickson couldn't find it, but it is off of his skates and goes out of the zone anyways.
He almost came out with it a few times.
Harwell under a little bit of pressure there from Hickson. Kroll almost fans on it. Emery unable to really jump on that one. Rundle high off the glass, just barely below the netting, and it goes down the ice. Hartwell will leave it for Bird. Bird coming up the ice. He works over to the left wing now. Fumbled it for just a second. He's taken down. No call coming on that one. Eye picks up down the far side, and he'll just play it to O'Connell. O'Connell off the skates of Kolinen.
Wow.
Now here you go for Lawrence Tech. It's Rundle and Eye. Two on two, and Bird gets a piece of that one as the back checker. Kolinen picks it up off the stick of West. Loose puck in the center circle. And here you go. Here's a chance for Lawrence Tech. With the shot was Koontz, but it was stopped.
Trying to go just under the glove, but got the pad.
Now Gents able to steer that one away from Bird. Comes up to Eye. That is going to be called offside, but they rule that he didn't have it across the line, and Hubenschmidt will tag up. Potter gets the tip on it and goes up and out of play.
And just when right before they looked like they scored, they were really getting the puck everywhere for Lawrence Tech. It was just ended up in the area of a player, and they just weren't solid, but the puck kept turning to them. So it just felt like a little bit of momentum was coming their way with the puck itself, and not sure why not with Michigan, but they're starting to come around. It's got to connect better and a little more solid.
Starting to get there for sure for Lawrence Tech. Magdish feeds in the middle to McGowan. This is Boissonneau across the line, blocked into the corner by O'Connell behind the net. McGowan again. That is Scott actually back there. McGowan kind of fading out now to the right side. Two-on-one battle. Boissonneau decides now is his turn to try and get involved in this one, but it goes to Bigelow in the corner. He's bumped there by Scott, and Scott will send it towards the goal. It's off the side of it. Kapari, he's under a lot of pressure. Lawrence Tech feisty there on the forecheck. O'Connell stretched up ice, gets it off the stick of Potter and in deep. Kroll will go out and play it. And able to get it past. Now Bigelow has it though in the corner. But only for a second as Boissonneau to McGowan, almost not on the same page. Cesarini across the line, he dumps it down. Polzin will leave it. Emery stretched right up the ice. Kudenko stops. It looked like he was trying to get the redirect and send that in. Into the glove of Polzin. He's going to hang on here for a faceoff. 14:15 to go, and it'll be to his left.
Yeah, it's starting to pick up a little bit. That's the pace we need. Still a 1-0 game.
One out to the point for Gents. It's blocked by Matthews, and now down low. Cesarini along the wall tries to cycle, but back there was Hartwell. He lofts it all the way down, and this one is going to be played by Kroll, so no icing. Koontz heads up as Kudenko might have been sizing him up. And
got a penalty.
Checking from behind again. We have been getting loaded on the check from behinds today.
He's talking to Hartwell. Hartwell's heading in maybe, or he's just asking what's going on?
I don't know. I'm going to try and see what's going on here.
Petterly's heading in the box.
I completely missed whatever that was. So.
Whoever he hit, still upright. I didn't see anybody laying there, but he must have really walloped him where we can't see. Penalty 6:03 on Petterly for the check from behind.
Have never seen more checking from behinds called in college hockey until this weekend.
Yeah, at least they're not serious majors.
Yeah, maybe mostly out-of-town refs that we've had this weekend. And maybe checking from behind is not that signal to some other places. I mean, that would just be just weird. I know it's not, but whatever. Eye across the blue line. Lawrence Tech again on the power play. Eye still with it. Now over to the far side. He'll stop up along the hash. He gets it to the center point for James Gents. That is blocked by Kolinen and out of the zone offside.
Yeah,
that is going to be all the way down maybe. We'll see. Kolinen wants it to be, but the linesman is kind of pointing at this faceoff dot right outside the zone, and it looks like that is where it's going to be.
Yes, it's not intentional there. I mean, he just played it on the line, and it was, and the officials tried to give the warning, but how do you stop that momentum there? I mean, they got the man advantage, and they can't see from back there. You're just hoping, you're relying on your defenseman to keep it.
Yep. Lawrence Tech will win the draw. Matavi, broken up. Here comes Bird. Bird with the shot. It's stopped by Kroll.
Wow, and plays it. He saw it when it popped in front of him, and he played it. Wow, he's got good reaction time there.
Yeah, he does. Just lets it drop, and here we go. Now it's McGowan. He flips it into the corner. Hartwell ranges over. He hammers it around, and with no point man, that should get out. Bird is in a foot race here. He's turning on the Jets. He's not going to get this one, at least right now. He's still fighting for it. He is going to eat some time here, but it is eventually wrestled away by Lawrence Tech. Starting it up ice, this is Rundle. Rundle floats it in there. Hartwell trying to rim it around again, and same old, same old. Yeah. It goes all the way down. 40 seconds now on the power play.
They're taking advantage of the defenseman coming in on the right side and just clearing it easy.
We'll see if Lawrence Tech adjusts. You would think they have to, and that is cleared and hits off the glass and stays in play. Played around now, and picking this one up is going to be Hickson. Cutting across into the center lane. Now it's to the right side. Makarchuk watching over him. O'Connell trying to separate man from puck, but Hickson still with the play. West trying to work it out. He can't get it past Jentz. Kept in there by Hickson. A nice keep from him as well. Back to even strength here in 2 seconds. Pulls in, pokes it away, and that is going to be the penalty killed as Matthews has the puck on his stick. He's trying to battle here, and now down behind the goal, O'Connell rims it up the wall. Matthews dodging the check there from Hubenschmidt, and it comes out to Jentz. Jentz, as West was coming in, had the opportunity to hit him, but didn't. And a weird bounce there. That would have been something, especially if it pinballed off Makarchuk. Sent all the way down. Kroll's going to play this one as Potter would be the first guy in, and Kroll's able to guide it to Jentz. Jentz with Kapari right in his face is able to get it out of the zone. And now intercepted by Kapari. He sends it back in. Kroll will play it. Let's Jentz get it. Now Cesarini gets it up to his stick. It's gloved down and still just sitting there. Now Bigelow gets it. Over to Potter. Bigelow again. Now controlling is Bland. Pace starting to really pick up a little bit in this one. Kuntz backhands it through the middle. It's broken up and down. Here we go. Cesarini with the drive, and it's kicked away.
Good stop there. Paulson.
Hartwell under duress here, trying to battle it away. Controlled by Scott. Potter down there. Goes now to Hartwell. He stretches it. It does. I don't know. That one might have gotten a piece of Bigelow, but they'll say it was clean, and we'll get icing.
They put a laser on Bigelow, and he just wasn't right position on that stick to pick that up. So, it looked like he was going to pick that up and go. Yeah, Lawrence Tech starting to come alive here, getting a little bit more crisp, and it's got Michigan a little bit on their heels here.
Yeah, very much coming alive are the Blue Devils so far. And with another offensive zone draw, it's up and out of play. As Bigelow might have had a 2-on-1 there with Potter if that one wouldn't have gone out.
He's like, I just want to take off. Mm-hmm. Like he's got the wheels. And he's just
Dearborn very much not letting Lawrence Tech try and make some of these changes. This is the game. This is how it goes. At this time of year, at this level, everything like that is just so important.
Yeah, West was over there too, like policing the bench.
So while it's a neutral site, having that higher seed, it is certainly an advantage. You get the last change. And so that could sometimes be the difference, especially a player like West. If Lawrence Heck were to try and shadow him, not having last change makes that a little bit more difficult. Bird. Over to Colonen. Colonen down the right side. He's trying to cut to net. Feeds it across. Rebound was still there. West had a piece of it.
Net's off.
Here we go the other way with Lawrence Tech. Looking for a penalty is Dearborn. Hem sends it across. Icing is going to be signaled for, but waved off. McCarchuk under a lot of pressure here. Oh. It's taken away by Hickson. Ooh, his shot is right into the chest of Polzin.
Man, good effort. Good heads-up play. And, you know, look, everyone's looking for calls, but Josh Hickson didn't care. He kept playing. Freshman fires off a shot. See if we can get this settled down now. I think they're still trying to figure out what personnel they want on the ice for Lawrence Tech.
Yeah, Dearborn making their changes now as well. Under the halfway mark here of the period. And it looks like Lawrence Tech again having issues with their change. Yeah.
They got to get it right. They're winning these faceoffs in the attacking zone, so you got to make the best of it. Just don't.
Loose puck out in front. Petterle is able to shield it. Kudenko plays it into the middle for Matthews. Matthews backhands it into the corner, and Sample is there for Lawrence Tech. Sample skating up ice. Goes across. Icing is signaled for. This time it is going to be called. Yep. But just as Lawrence Tech is again trying to make changes, we'll see if those are going to be allowed. And at least one player, that's Hubenschmidt, is going to be sent off. But one of the Lawrence Tech players did just make it off and get exchanged and is going to be able to stay on the bench.
It's picking up. At least the crowd's getting into it for us.
Well, certainly one member of the crowd got into it during the intermission.
Yeah.
Had some... I mean, they weren't bad words. He just had, you know, an exchange with the referee. Told him that that was a trip on I think that was on West, who would have been taking that penalty.
Yeah, we had questions about it.
Yeah, so you know what? I mean, not endorsing what he did, but yeah. I mean, his concerns, I understand where he's coming from. But the officials were just laughing about it. As I was walking down there at about that same time, they know what they're signing up for, unfortunately, so...
I'm surprised he didn't yell at you, hey, and you said my kid's name wrong, or something like that. Then it gets real scary.
No, when they start attacking me, that's when we got problems.
Yeah, we'll just go by numbers then.
Yeah, we will. Hey, we did that a little bit last week. Colonen with it now, feeds the Bird. High slap, Bird with the shot. It is blocked by Sample. Lofts it all the way up to the blue line. Colonen just able to keep it in. But now it is played out by I. All the way down. No icing going to be called on this one, though.
So here goes some changes now for Lawrence Tech.
Emery gets it over to Hartwell. Hartwell is in the middle of the ice. He doesn't get back to it, and it's sent back in. Colonen gets it up to Bird. Sent back in by I. And Hartwell has it behind the Dearborn goal. Bird gets around one. Doesn't get past another. Cesarini has it for the Blue Devils. Back to him now. Left circle. Takes a shot. It's blocked by Emery. West. Turned over. Cesarini a shot. That one was
still
blocked.
Alive. Nope.
Sent back in by Kuntz. And Hartwell will look to do it again here. Bird gets the redirect there off of Potter, who has a little bit of a shove there with Gents. Now Kroll to Kuntz. He's run through by Potter. And then we get another one coming. That is going to be a penalty on Gents. And now we get, I think, a little bit more of a gathering. No.
Give him a boarding call, I think. Let's see.
Yeah.
The official's pretty fired up about it. Not wavering on his call. Yep. Or so, charging, actually. Where are we at here? 12:08.
So, Gents back on the penalty sheet. That is his third of the game. I don't know if the rule where five and you're gone applies in college as well. But if it is, he is going to start approaching that here at this rate. He is on pace. So, power play for Dearborn. Big chance for them to make it a multi-goal lead, but it starts off okay for Lawrence Tech. Has no clean control, and then it is rimmed up to the blue line, but not past the point man, Kudenko. Petterle Now it's controlled by Bigelow. He goes to the point. Kudenko. Kudenko. His shot through and they score!
Wow.
Redirected in by Bigelow.
Wow. Kroll set up, but he just could not get that redirect. It's a power play goal.
So Quest Bigelow finds his way out in front. The shot comes through and gets the redirect on it. It is a power play goal for Michigan Dearborn with 7:28 still to go. And that didn't take too long on the power play. Still a minute 37 was left on that. And teams both are playing the line change game here, I think, deciding who they are going to put out. As the visitors, Lawrence Tech has to put their guys out first. And now Dearborn will get the chance to respond, is what I'm assuming this delay is for. And now there you go. Dearborn will put their guys out. So very much the game within the game here. And in a game that is going to probably be as tight as this one is and has been, you just got to find the little ways to squeeze out that extra 0.01, that extra little tenth or hundredth to come out ahead. So much on the line for both of these teams. Lawrence Tech probably safely into the national tournament, but right along the bubble for Dearborn. They might be the first team out, but a win here would go a long way for them, especially tomorrow, as obviously then they would be the automatic bid for the WAC.
Him, man, he worked up there and tried to get it fed when he got on board, but that was it.
Couldn't get much more coming out of that. Now under the 7-minute mark, here comes Michigan Dearborn. Emery rims it in, and down into the corner is Hickson. Hickson heads up
wow.
as West decides not to lean into him. That would have been a high-speed crash. Here's West now along the near side. Works his way. It's poked away from him. And now here we go. Lawrence Tech, a potential breakaway
here.
Hickson all on his lonesome, but it's offside.
Oh, we weren't looking at that. We were just looking to see if he could pick up the pass. Yeah, he must have squeezed up a little bit.
I think that's the second time that that kind of thing has happened to Lawrence Tech, where they could have had a opportunity at the net and it stopped for offside. Just a little bit too eager.
He's not happy. Yeah, and it wasn't a rifled shot. I mean, they had some fumbling there where he could have, yeah, you didn't have to chase it out too hard, but yeah, man. That's what the lines are there for.
So it'll be a face-off just outside the Lawrence Tech zone. Everyone is all good with who they have out there. Kapari to the draw. McGowan does a good job tying it up and winning that one for his team. Scott is tied up with Potter. They were going to play on after that one, and Dearborn not liking that. I think both teams are going to have beef with how this game has been officiated. And maybe rightly so at this point. A couple of things they definitely have let go that could have been called, especially the standard they set earlier in the game with that interference penalty to Gents. O'Connell is back there. McGowan racing in, but still controlled now. It's Makarchuk. Makarchuk skates it ahead. He cuts into the middle, trying to dodge the checks. He gets it over to Potter, but it's off of his stick and onto that of Gents. Looking for the play right up, but he sends it right into Bigelow, as that was higher out here, looking to go on a little breakaway, or at least have an opportunity at the net.
Yeah,
speaking
nice.
Of higher, here he comes.
Yeah, he's got to work for it now.
Petterly, reverse play. Kudenko is over there. Emery will pick it up, though. This defenseman getting active offensively, and that one might be a little too much on it, and it is. That'll be icing.
Yeah, let's see what Lawrence Tech's going to elect a full change. See if they can mismatch this this line of Michigan. The Wolverines will come back and see what they can do, if they can just get it out, get a chance, or get a change.
Demo I and Petterly to the draw. Comes to Kuntz. His shot goes nowhere. Kudenko is able to backhand it out. That one is going to be icing as well.
Not too bad, because they didn't have to skate any on that, so they can catch their breath. Blue Devils off to face off, and now it's going to be picked up Michigan.
Kudenko pinned to the wall by Kuntz. big battle. Lots of players each side. Here's a shot from Hubenschmidt off the side of the net. Pulls in, goes out to cover it, and gets a cover on that one. But if he didn't, that could have been very dangerous.
Yeah, Kuntz was in there. I think he got a stick in there just as Poulsen was covering. So he could have dug that out and did anything he wanted with it. But Poulsen committed so far wide and out and behind.
.506 here in the second period. Lawrence Tech back on the attack after having given up that power play goal to Quest Bigelow on the redirect. Emery off the wall, and it does squeak out. Bird, he's lit up there by Sample, another big hit from number two in blue. Emery has a little bit of time here. He finds Kolonen streaking through the middle. Now here goes Kolonen. Kicks it back out to West. West with the shot. Kroll with the hand controlled by Lawrence Tech, but West is down there. He's trying to take it away. He's still down on his bum and trying to take it away. Hem floats it all the way down. That's going to go on goal and is going to be held by Poulsen as we don't get any extracurriculars
there. Yeah, I thought when Rundle got in there, but they don't want to be further down. Yeah, that was another good battle with Priest and West back there. And after it was over, there was no whacking of sticks or any anger. They just know that they're both playing just great physical hockey.
Out to the point. Matavi with a shot. It's blocked down in front. And now back to Poulsen, and he's able to get the cover on it.
Yeah, he's just trying to get a hold of it and keep it alive, but he ended up getting a shot. And Poulsen shut it down. He stayed with it. Just took a tomahawk there, and it was a chance. West is out. We're coming out on the
shift him a little bit here. This isn't his usual line.
Yeah, they sent Kapari in there, so
maybe a little bit of a matchup situation here. Now here comes West, fresh off the bench, down to the left wing, trying to feed for Potter, and it's stopped by Kroll.
Wow, and he looked down and he got it. And I'm not, man, he's playing solid. It looked like he had some room, but he had confidence in where to go to get that puck. So this is one of the first times you'll see West on the ice without Priest. So let's see what. I think he's back on the bench.
Yeah. So West will, no, he is still out there. And Priest looks like he is on the bench.
Well, this will be interesting. Let's see who steps up.
Down to the last 4:13. Kolonen has Bird lined up.
Oh,
I see. In the spot where they're trying to get the shot, but Kolonen can't win the draw, and it is chipped off the glass by Kuntz and out. Makarchuk will track all the way back.
It's Pelé's job now to stay with West.
Hubenschmidt trying to send it back down in. And Makarchuk off the wall, and it stays in. Hubenschmidt able to get over there.
Oh.
O'Connell pokes it into the corner where Makarchuk is. He's hit into the wall. Kolonen is over there as a part of the duo for UMD as they win that puck battle. Bird trying to lead it for West. Here goes West into some open ice a little bit. Just as I say that, it's knocked away by him. And open ice is a relative term tonight for West. And that is scooped by Poulsen.
Keeping the play alive, and it just gets in the area of Poulsen, and he shuts down any attempt of momentum for LT to get something there. Going for their effort. 3:24 remaining, and they got to get something going soon. We've seen this in the last game. We keep thinking that the other team will put something up, but so far today we see just one team coming out, taking charge right away and for the long haul.
Picks into the faceoff. He's able to win it. Backhands it through the goal mouth, but nobody home for Lawrence Tech. Comes over to Sample now. He puts it on the stick of Pelé. Pelé across the line and now into the corner. Waiting for some reinforcements, but he fans on that pass, and it's sent out to center by Hartwell. Gents Doesn't find the stick of Pillay. There's Emery for Hartwell. And nice play in the middle. Two on one potentially. Petterly, as he's got a back checker all over him, gets the shot off anyways. It goes wide. Emery sends that one cross corner. Hem gets it off the wall, and it is into the UMD bench. And those guys have had to have their heads up today.
Yeah, they're catching a lot of souvenirs out there. And they throw it back on the ice, keep that cold puck in action and in play. As we hear Dancing Queen by Haba.
Gotta love it. Bringing it out now is McGowan. Sends it cross corner. Hartwell is over there. Ooh. Clears it out to the point. Uh-oh. High soaring puck. Over to the near wall now, and we get a hand pass.
I would have done that. So good effort there. Good heads up. Morsek had one guy there waiting for it to drop. Look at this, what's going on here. I'm sure Hartwell had a little trouble coming to the ice. That's what they were waiting on.
And now we're back to it, though. They get it sorted out. Been a trend this period is everyone kind of making sure their line changes are on point. Along the near half wall. Pinned to the wall there by a Dearborn player. Can't get a number on him from this angle, but that player is doing a tremendous job of just eating time here. It might be Bigelow. It's still over there. Now he goes down to the ice, and he is slow to get up, too. He's still laying down. And so...
Yeah, he's asking for help.
Yeah, that is... Bigelow.
It is Bigelow.
It is.
Yeah.
And looks like it might be a shoulder thing for him. And Lawrence Tech, their penalty box door is open, but I don't know if that's just for the trainer to try and get through or not. Bigelow is able to get to his feet.
Yeah, let's hope he's all right. Quest Bigelow, the senior out of Rochester Hills, Michigan. Used to play AAA hockey for Bell Tire. Let's see. Let's hope the Bell Tire experience puts him back on the road to play the rest of this game. I hope he's all right. He sure was getting he was getting driven over, if we want to stick with it, and he battled, so they couldn't just pick up an easy pickup. And so hats off to him, and he paid the price for it physically. Hope he's all right.
Absolutely. So now down to the last 1:48 of this period, and really doing a great job there, killing a lot of time, killed probably close to 15 seconds just eating that one along the wall. But it is an offensive zone draw for Lawrence Tech. It's eye to the face off and Cullinan for Dearborn. It is won by Cullinan. As he tries to work this one out, gets it out past Bird. Now West into the neutral zone, doesn't have much help. Puts it in the middle, O'Connell. O'Connell with the chance here still. It's Rock.
He scores! Wow,
he
was getting tied up. And he just, he maintained, but he didn't gather it up. He still shot while he was kind of almost on a knee.
He really was. Just recovered enough to be able to put it in. There was a delayed penalty on that one coming anyways. I think I saw the ref's arm up, but it doesn't matter as Kieran O'Connell is able to put it home. O'Connell, not exactly a goal scorer, trying to track down his number for the season. That is number 4 of the year for him. And it comes at a very good time for the Wolverines. And we've got a penalty on, it's still going to be called. That is on Hubenschmidt for Lawrence Tech. So not sure what that was for. It would probably be for the tripping before the play anyways.
Yeah. He was taking him down, and he never gave up.
Yeah, so a bad situation for Lawrence Tech. They go down 3-0, and they still end up shorthanded here as they try and battle back into this one. But Dearborn, been on a heater the last few weeks, and that is continuing here today. They lead 3-0 as we approach the last minute of the middle frame.
Seeing daily similarities so far in these matchups today.
Kudenko gets it to Bigelow, and Bigelow tries to send it in. He keeps it in now. Good to see him back out there as he takes the hit there from Sample. Emery with the shot through, looking for West. It's in his skates. Sample going to lock down West as best as he can. Now Bigelow, though, is the threat, and it's sent around to the point for Kudenko. He can't get there in time, and he'll have to back out. We have another penalty coming to Lawrence Tech as well now. The referee's arm is up again. And it looks like Polson is just going to wait this one out. He's not going to head for the bench. Here is Hartwell. His shot is redirected. It comes to West at the near wall. Down to about 10 seconds. Out to Hartwell. Left point. He tees off. Hit stopped by Kroll. It's up in the air. And then played
fast
out.
Whistle.
But we do get the whistle because Lawrence Tech touches up. So the penalty draws the whistle with 8 seconds left. And it is Garrett Sample going to the box.
Yeah, this is not what they need to try to get back in this. This is only the second period, and they can let this get lost here really fast.
Yeah, so 31 seconds of 5-on-3 or less. We have 8 more seconds of the period, and that is going to tick off harmlessly, as that will do it for the second period. Nothing more will come of it, but when we get back, it'll be 23 seconds of 5-on-3 time for UMD, and then more 5-on-4 time after that. They lead it 3-0 through 40 minutes. We'll go ahead and take a break. The WAC Men's Ice Hockey Tournament brought to you by SummitCitySports.com.
Want to know the difference between dreaming and doing? Yeah, pretty much everything. Visit Indiana Tech and see what it's like to be a warrior. Tech goes by many names. Business, fine art, forensic science. Some think it's just technical. But really, tech means everything. Scholarships, internships, championships. It's professors who make time for you one-on-one. It's putting everything on the line. It can be fierce. It can be fascinating. It can be awesome. Most important, it's believing in yourself and what you have to offer the world. Because at Indiana Tech, warriors are prepared to lead a significant life. You're busy. You expect to say no sometimes. But what you didn't expect was a chance to say yes to a college degree while keeping your life. Indiana Tech is now offering Chicago area students undergraduate and graduate degree opportunities taught online by experienced faculty who care. Learn more at one of the new Indiana Tech enrollment centers in Naperville or Wilmette.
I can turn this in early? Sure, whenever you're ready.
Embrace the unexpected at Indiana Tech.
Well, first of all, I'd like to say that there aren't very many energy programs out there. When I researched all of the various programs recently, there are really only 2 or 3 accredited engineering programs.
I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada originally. I came out here to Indiana Tech to actually go for the energy engineering program because of its uniqueness and its ability to get hands-on with the materials that I'm going to be using in the future.
Well, a few of the things I think that sets Indiana Tech apart is, number one, you have very small classes. You have very close relationships with your professors. When you have a class of 10 people, it's much easier to get to know the professor and get in contact with him than if you have a class of 30, 40, or 50. You're going to have the same professors for the majority of your classes. You're going to have the same classmates. for the majority of your classes.
The more practical applications come in all the subsequent energy engineering classes. Heat transfers in a class that right after they're leaving the classroom, and the board is filled with calculus. So in order to understand a lot of these topics, they're going to need to understand the calculus there. Calculus is the study of the rate of change, how fast things change. And depending upon whether it's energy engineering, industrial engineering, or whatever, they're going to need to use that and apply that.
Professor Romary, he stands out to me the most right now because when I first got here, I had to take calculus, Calc 1, Calc 2. And he's one of the professors that teaches it. And he just really was a very kind and helpful guy. And he did whatever he could to help us out. He was very funny, always had a way of creatively teaching calculus to us that not a whole lot of people can do. And I think that and how he did it is going to be something that's going to stick for me for a very long time.
The field work that Indiana Tech can provide here is, for example, we have a 10 kilowatt windmill that the students can work with. We have a geothermal system for a couple of the buildings for Yutengsu and for Zollner that uses geothermal principles to heat and cool the buildings in the summer and the winter.
The PV array system, training system that we have down here in the basement allows us to wire up the panels we have down in the basement to set it up as a off-the-grid system or a battery bank system, which helps us because we can see every component of the system actually intertwining and how they work together with something that may not be easily visible when you're on the job site in a career. So definitely my internship at Super Value Incorporated was a very, very beneficial program for me to be in. It was more based on the process and logistical side of engineering of my degree, not necessarily the design aspect. It helped me really learn how the most efficient way to do a task and some of the boundaries that come with trying to make things more efficient.
One of the things that we've been very fortunate here at Indiana Tech is that we've had a grant through AEP to help subsidize our students in taking some of the various trips in spring break. Over the last 4 years, I have taken, along with a couple of other chaperones, I've taken almost a couple of dozen students to a trip to Germany and Switzerland that focused on renewable energy. We've gone to Iceland last year, focusing on geothermal energy, and we just recently returned from a trip to Costa Rica.
Just last year, I went to Iceland with a couple of our peers. Not even just energy engineers, but a couple of other engineering majors went along with us. And for me, that was the highlight of my college time. I mean, we learned a lot about like geothermal systems and how they converted to a country of basically like ran just by geothermal. But it wasn't just learning about that. It was also learning about their culture as well, you know, and the past and the history and where they plan to go in their future. And all those things combined, I think, really, really kind of defines my experience here in Indiana Tech.
You can be the smartest engineer in the world, but if you cannot talk to or work with other engineers and non-engineers, it's very hard to get anything done. I try to teach my students that while you may not like writing, it's going to be a part of the job. You have to communicate if you're doing experiments or testing hardware in the lab. You need to write it up so that other people know what you did, and the customer may want to know what are the results of that test.
Something I would remember most about the faculty would be just the one-on-one aspect of it and how open they are to hearing your problems and concerns and willing to assist you. Indiana Tech, with the class sizes being so small, you really get that one-on-one talking, everyday type relationship with your advisors and your professors. And having that is key to success, I feel, because being able to communicate with them and actually get your problems and questions across is going to help clarify things for you while you're in classes and school, which is going to set you up for success.
Welcome to the Summit City, home to the 260's dedicated high school athletes and fans. Each victory and celebration captured by our cameras. treasure the highlights from the Summit Athletic Conference this season, or complete games live or on demand. After all, nobody's more proud to call Fort Wayne home than SummitCitySports.com.
Want to know what it means to be a warrior? Yeah, pretty much everything. Visit Indiana Tech and walk a mile in a warrior's shoes. You want to know what's possible at Indiana Tech? Yeah, pretty much everything. Visit Indiana Tech and see what it's like to be a warrior.
Welcome back inside the Sport One Park View Ice House. Second intermission here between the Wolverines and the Blue Devils. It's a 3-0 lead for Lawrence Tech. A 3-0 lead for UM-Dearborn for Lawrence Tech. They got a mountain to climb here.
Yeah, I think they're just getting a little frustrated out there. They've not really, I mean, they have their moments of playing well, but they have played the same package throughout this game consistently, and it's just not enough against this great team of the Wolverines. So the Blue Devils have got to do something, and they're going to have to come out here in a paradigm shift and do something a little bit different than they have been. And they got to stay calm. They're starting to get frustrated, and that's too early, especially the end of that period. I mean, that's why I recognize, hey, this is only the second period, and they're starting to let it get away from them. So they got to gather it up and I think be a lot more, you know, quick-witted and even temperament as they get down here and try to get something. Kroll is doing well. Yeah, he's gave up three, but, man, some of those, they're just, you know, he got one where he was, you know, on a screen, never saw it. But he's been battling pretty strong because it could be 15 to nothing if it wasn't for him.
Absolutely. It's been a good period, though, for Lawrence Tech the other way. They've gotten some chances. It's just Eric Polson doing the thing in net for UMD. And I think one of the big things for Lawrence Tech is that they've been shutting down West, but then it hasn't really made much of a difference. It's still 3-0 for Dearborn.
Yeah, West did that short shift a little bit earlier. That was really interesting. And got to see, you know, who else could come in there, and it was Pelé that tied him up. So they're staying focused on him. They're letting the rest of the team, though, creep in and take chances, and they've got to, you know, it's a smart move. You can't let him have his game, but West is humble and mature enough to say, hey, the rest of my team can do it. Make it stay on me the rest of the night. We're up by three, so let's see if that changes any on their strategy.
Yeah, so the winner of this one obviously advances to the WAC championship game tomorrow, 1 o'clock puck drop. Their opponent will not be Indiana Tech, like I'm sure many were expecting. It is going to be the Concordia Cardinals, and we'll take a flashback to earlier this afternoon and see how the Cardinals got it done. When we come back, it'll be about time for the third period. You're watching the WAC Men's Ice Hockey Tournament, brought to you by SummitCitySports.com. For Hebner in the left corner, stretched up ahead. Making a break is Benoit, has Francois breaking. Oh. Francois with the shot in, Barnhill with the save.
It's loose.
Ali has Derek Hebner with some moves, trying to work it back in, but it's on the stick of Austin Buck. Now he stretches it up for Ali. One-on-one with Kucera. Ali with the help for Smith, and it's stopped by Janus.
Boy.
Does a good job to fight that one back, though. Plummer with the turnover to Twombly. To Hebner, a one-timer. That's blocked. Rebound is there, and they score.
Oh, Campbell came in.
Dugan taken down. Bienik is over there. Ali gets it out to Dugan. Dugan trying to turn on the Jets. Here we go. TJ Dugan with the move, and he stopped. That might have hit the post.
I think it did. It was
Benoit with Mickey Fork all over him for a second. Now Benoit will play it towards the goal. It's gloved by Carruthers. Loose puck. Plummer is able to slow it up. Aya with the shot, and he scores.
So if there was baseball, we'd be caught.
With control for the Warriors. Smith now skating up ice. He's across the line. Wrapping this one around. Still hanging on. Tries the wraparound. It scores!
Now they're washing it. They're washing it.
Edgar dumps it in. Goes in deep. Buck is back there. Turns it over to Edgar. trying to wrap it in, scores. Concordia leads 3-0. Left wall sent towards the goal. Hyatt had a potential chance there. Goes to Rydell now near side. He works it out to the point for Kucera. His shot through traffic and scores.
He never saw
it out to the blue line to Chabot. Dufort at the left point. He'll trade with Chabot. Keeps the puck. Over to Granquist, the one-timer. But the roller still there. And it stays out.
It's the best they're looking here, so they got to get her going.
His tails. Dufort. Last man back. Got to be careful here, and here you go. It's a breakaway coming the other way for Tails. Can Dugan catch him?
Yes, he can. Does. Good stick on that. Dufort.
And a little bit of a sketchy play there, but it works out. Here we go with Dufort. Goes over to Lowe. Down to 40 seconds. Lowe cutting to the net. Lowe with the shot. Rebound is there, and the second chance opportunity is kept out by Janus. Again to Chabot. Right out in front. They score!
They finally get one. Power play goal. Out and face
all
this
right,
crowd.
Welcome back. You know, I'd be right. So anyways, as we pick that back up for a second, we have one less Lawrence Tech fan in the crowd who had been sent out of here for kind of talking to the referees as they were walking back to their locker room. But one thing we'll talk about is that game between Concordia and Indiana Tech. A bit of a shocker, Bryce. Obviously, Indiana Tech, the number one overall seed, only three losses. Expected to be in that championship game, but they're not. It was Concordia. Well, how do you think Concordia was kind of able to win, and what do you think they might be able to take from that and apply to tomorrow as well?
I think they just never gave up, and maybe they even thought to themselves, I mean, everybody, you know, you shouldn't be in a game if you don't think you can win it no matter what. And I think they just played by period, or, you know, shift, by period, and stayed systematically even. And they just never let off, and they just kept, you know, and it worked for them. They're like, wow, we got a goal. And then they just kept digging and digging, and they didn't do anything spectacular, crazy changes, going the, you know, between ice cuts and do anything different. They just played their game. They played it systematically, the best they know how, and it worked. And, you know, what was some of the errors, like you were saying, we were talking, what are the errors that Indiana Tech had to be interesting to see? And you can go back and review it. But did they take advantage of it? But I think that Concordia just played a very even game, and they just it just was perfect for them. And kind of what the Wolverines are doing here, and I think Lawrence Tech is missing that because they need to just dial in that, and they just haven't made that. They got spurts. They got this and that pretty good. They get and when it looks like you're gathering the puck all the time because what's the old cliche? A puck always goes to good players, and they're just – it's not fine-tuning it. And if they can in this period, they can make something happen. You got 20 minutes to do it. And we've seen goals scored last night with Lawrence Tech in a little short period of time.
Yeah, they can really turn it on in the third period. They're going to really need to turn it on in this third period. There was a little discussion there going on between some of the leaders from each team with the referees. We'll see. Some criticism towards the referees. Probably a fair point in this game. And we'll see how things shake out here. We've got 20 minutes on the board, 23 seconds of 5-on-3 here still for Dearborn, and then some good time as well, still at 5-on-4 after that, as we are back underway for the final frame. Dearborn getting situated here. Kudenko drops it back for Emery, and Dearborn is almost just going to kill the rest of this 5-on-3 on their own as they try and get themselves together here. Kudenko will leave it for Matthews across the line, and now we go to 5-on-4. Matthews working his way around behind the goal to Petterle at the top of the circle. His shot is blocked into the corner. Emery gets it in deep. Over to Emery again in the corner. Gets it out to the left point for Kudenko. He tees off on that one. It's blocked away by I. Still in the front of the net region. And now that is going to be not too many. Just in the nick of time on that
close change.
Hickson, you know what? If he would have been about half a second earlier, would have called it. But that player he was changing for was at least straddling the bench. So
sure would have been a heartache just clearing one. Getting another one in the box.
Yeah, then another long 5-on-3. Still 47 seconds here as Brendan West works his way in. On the back and takes his shot, and Kroll is able to swallow that one up.
Yeah, that was a nice effort by West there, saying, hey, look, let me be free, and he has. And at least on that shift there, and Kroll gathered it up pretty well.
Still 42 seconds to work with here for the Wolverines as they look to make it 4-0. And like we said with Concordia, at that point it becomes a little bit of a stranglehold. Still plenty of time, though, if they were to score it now. When Concordia scored, this was about halfway through. O'Connell to the slot for Cullinan. It's blocked away. Cullinan gets it back and goes to Hartwell at the left point. Down the wall to Bird. Bird around one, lost the handle on it, though. Able to work it back. Now it's with West. He goes to the top of the point for O'Connell. Bird looking to make a pass across, but it is now cleared out to the blue line, but kept. Cullinan across. It's off of Bird now to West. Cullinan trying to go over to West. He's at it now to Bird. Touch pass for Hartwell. Sends it towards the goal. It goes wide. Back to even strength as Sample steps out of the box. West evades that one. Nice little moves. Here's West in the circle with the shot. And it goes beyond into the corner. Bird chipped up to O'Connell. Knocked down by Bird. Trying to get around a man. That is Kuntz. Kuntz with it now. Wraps it around behind the goal. And Heyer will play it all the way down the ice. No icing going to be called, as that is Gents going back there with Makarchuk.
Oh, he
right,
faked
here's
it.
A shot. Oh, rebound still wow. there. And Cullinan guides it to safety as pulls it, wow. is up to it there.
Yeah, he just dropped it blind, and it was a pass on tape.
It worked out as Heyer wanted to step right into that one. Kapari. Now this is Bigelow, one of the goal scorers. He's run off into the wall. Magdish up and out of the zone. Emery sends it back in. Offside play. Dearborn will have to tag up and get set to reattack here. About 3 minutes gone. That is about a foot and a half too high on the attempt from French.
Yeah, French, you saw something, and the glass isn't our height. So I don't know if there is a rink with super tall glass. I thought we had some pretty tall glass around here. Well, at least in the back.
Adequately tall glass. It's moderate. I've played at rinks where it's very short, and yeah, good thing delay game up out of play isn't a penalty at any of the levels I played. Otherwise, I'd be in trouble. Makarchuk trying to fire it towards the goal. Kapari as well, but he fans on it, and Kroll gets it with the glove on the try from Bigelow.
Yeah, he wasn't going the right direction for the Blue Devils, so Kroll shuts down the play, and they'll hit the reset button on this attempt. Looks like changes only for the Blue Devils, as the Wolverines like what they have on the ice.
Kapari to the draw, sends it right on to Kroll, who is able to handle it. Cesarini up, and that hits, I think, this tube insulation type thing we've got going on.
Yeah.
That you'll never see in the camera shot, but it is just above the netting along the ceiling area.
Yeah, it's the, I believe, the air handling duct for the, believe it or not, heat somewhere in this place, but not where we're at.
Yeah, I think that definitely might be running into the restaurant. Not getting it over here.
Yeah. So we got tall ceilings here, but not tall enough for that launching of the puck. As we hear YMCA, but
yeah,
by the Village people.
You know what? The end of the season is always bittersweet, but I will be a little bit happy to not have to listen to some of the songs that are in this playlist every weekend. The warm-up playlist is fire, and there are some good ones in the game playlist, but there are some that I'm like, we need to update this, guys. That's not my job, though. That's someone else's. Goes all the way down. Pulls in, is going to play it back up the near wall, but it's a turnover. Sent towards the goal. Rebound is still there, and it's sent just high by Scott.
Wow. Paulson went down, but he hopped up quick to see if it was coming back at him, but it launched up big time. And then we're going to finish out the YMCA.
Keep it going. Some days I would do it. Today is not one of those days.
Yeah.
It'll be a face-off to the left of Polzin, who to this point still hangs on. Lawrence Tech, their bench getting quite fired up for this offensive zone draw, and they win it as an indirect result. Could have played a factor, though. I guess we'll never know for sure. Comes out in the middle.
Oh.
Kudenko turned it over. Matthews, though, is going to be able to start it out. And Petterly gets around one. He's got some sick checks, though, but still has it. Drops it to Matthews. Matthews towards the goal.
Oh,
rebound
no.
is loose out in front for Kudenko, but he couldn't send it on. hangs on to it. Now Lawrence Tech makes it a 3-on-2 battle, but Petterly still keeps it pinned along the wall. We saw Bigelow doing this, and maybe Dearborn just going to kill some time here towards the backside, but it's behind Matavi.
Yeah, if he put it on target, he would have had a chance.
Up to Matthews now. Skates this one up ice, gains the line, and a little bit more than that, and he'll go for a change. Over to the far side now, Colonen strips it away, but it's loose in the skates of Priest. And now Colonen having it pinned to the wall. It is brought free by Lawrence Tech, and Hickson starts it up ice. Misses the pass to Rundle, now down into the corner. McCarchuk and O'Connell are there, and O'Connell has control of it. He goes over to McCarchuk. McCarchuk with some pressure from Rundle here, but he's
Rundle's
handling it
well.
For now. Now down goes McCarchuk. Rundle still hounding it. Finally some separation for UMD.
Yeah, he's not letting them hold that puck because they're just trying to eat some clock time here. And he's letting them know, hey, you're not going to get this easy.
Now Bird keeps it in along the line. Couldn't get it down the ice to West. Now Hickson comes back the other way again for the Blue Devils. Across the line, he'll stop up as soon as he gets in. Colin and pesters him, but Hickson able to get it down low. It's McCarchuk. He's just going to give it to West. Don't know if that's what he was trying to do, but you're never going to complain about giving it to West, I think.
No.
He's got some speed, but it's forced off his stick and into the corner. Trying to get around French. He gets tied up. Still a loose puck. Kapari comes in to try and get this one and has it. Gets it out to Hartwell. He has a drive, and it's into the glove of Kroll.
Yeah. As we saw Priest and West going at it, Kroll is there doing his job. He has a pretty good shift. I'm starting to enjoy watching Hickson when he gets a hold of the puck. He's just creating a chance. He makes himself small and gets anywhere he needs to on the ice. So I like to see that a little more effective for the Blue Devils.
Still trailing by 3 is Lawrence Tech. UMD swept Lawrence Tech last weekend in the home and home, and took 3 of 4 games from Lawrence Tech in the regular season. They're hoping to make it 4 of 5 overall in the season if they can hang on here for the last 13 minutes and 45 seconds. Hartwell calmly navigates it into the middle of the ice for Kapari. Kapari brings it across the line, puts it through the skates of Magdish on his backhand. Doesn't have a centering opportunity, so he cycles for Bigelow. Bigelow, he's got his stick tied up. Around now, Potter. Trying to fight it back from Magdish and played up the wall. And now here we go the other way for Lawrence Tech. It's higher. Higher's shot is blocked right there by Petterly. Still has it though. McCarchuk trying to get it away from him. A little battle over in the corner now. And Lawrence Tech controls to Jentz, but it's knocked away from him by Potter.
It's off.
Jentz and Potter were tied up there. And we'll get the whistle.
That was a pretty good battle right there. Mm-hmm. But the puck was just a little, got across the line there, so physicality looking good for both sides. But the issue is the Blue Devils have got to get something going here, so they got to answer on that part.
Dumped in by Kuntz, pulls in, has it jump over his stick, so it comes into the near side corner. Jumps over the stick of Pille there, and O'Connell will set up for the Wolverines. He starts to play ahead, gets around a couple, still has it. Now will dish off to Kudenko, who will tilt the stick and ramp that one in. Lawrence Tech not on the same page here. Kudenko gets over to the wall, but Pille keeps him pinned to the wall as he can't get back to the puck. Hubenschmidt able to work it out. Hartwell hammers it across as UMD makes changes. Matthews trying to push it back down.
Oh, good pass.
Comes to Hubenschmidt. His shot is redirected by Hartwell. It goes into the corner. Hartwell taken to the wall. Here's Colonen, gets it up to Matthews. As it looks like some different looks coming here from UMD, albeit they are, I think, in the middle of a line change. In neutral ice, it's Hem. Now here you go, they will get the top unit out there. Hem still has it. His shot forced wide.
Wow, he grabs his own attempt.
Emery comes out right in front to Cullinan. He gets around one but loses the puck. It comes out, though. Sent right back in by Priest. Icing disallowed there. It's waved off. And now
got West all the way up here on that stretch pass pickup.
Trying to get him some open ice and still not really able to do it too well, as he's been rendered pretty ineffective for the most part in this one. Kept off the score sheet. Bird sends it towards the Lawrence Tech end. Hem rims it around this near side. Karchuk is there. He is put into the wall. Fire on those two. That's a heavy collision.
Yeah, and he kept it in.
West gets around one. We have a whistle and a penalty.
Interference.
That is, I would imagine, going to be the one on Rundle. And he's slowly making his way to the box with the linesman alongside, so it looks like it will be on Keegan Rundle. So a fresh two-minute power play for UMD. Looking to separate and really make a stranglehold lead here. 4-0. Shot through by Kadega. Oh. Rebound is in front. Bigelow can't finish the job, though. He's looking for number two on the night.
Kroll had to play that puck twice, and he saved the day, and they get it cleared.
Here's Emery. Goes over to Kudenko, who chips it into Bigelow. Has a man breaking towards the backside. It's Matthews. Doesn't go for it. Now here is Kudenko again along the goal line with the backhand. Still with it, and it's stopped by Kroll.
Wow. And good defense there to help. A little bit of opening there they could have squeaked it in on. I think that was off the effort there of Hoogensmith.
That was just barely onside for Kudenko as Polson played it right back up the ice. Kudenko goes across the seam to Kolonen. Into the corner. Has it with his backhand. Kolonen gets it up to the left point for Emery. Emery with his shot through. There was daylight. Looked like there was a good screen there from Bigelow. West gathers this one up, cutting through the slot, puts it into the corner. He tries to chase it back down himself, but Sample is there. Now it's Kolonen. Tries to go across, but misfires on the pass. Down to 45 seconds on the man advantage. Sent cross ice. Hartwell under pressure here. Pille takes it, tries to center it, but nowhere in the same zip code as that pass was going.
Oh, he's got a hold of it.
I sends it down low. It's West. Looking to play it back up the wall. He'll just reverse it to Hartwell with 25 more seconds. Probably one or two more runs up the ice for Dearborn. Hartwell with speed down to the left side. He'll stop up in the faceoff dot. Backhands it across to the wall. O'Connell takes a shot and it goes high. Comes around to Hartwell. Goes back down low. Five more seconds as Bird picks up. Gives it to O'Connell. O'Connell back down to Bird on the half wall. Bird with a couple of circles, tight turns. Now Kolonen as we go back to even strength. Rimmed over to this side and it's out past Scott. Hartwell hammers it around. Linesman getting out of the way of that one and it's off Cole's stick, out of play.
Yeah, he tried to shut her down and he just sailed her up the safety netting. So now we get all the correct lines set back up, but that'll be in the Lawrence Tech's defensive zone. See if they can win the faceoff and get something going down ice. 8:49 remaining in the third. They need something here.
That they do. We'll see if UMD can keep the pressure up, though. Coming off of that power play, they're trying to get Gents free. It might work out.
Nice.
He's going to be first one there with Emery. He picks it up, looking out into the slot. Centering feed was kind of hindered there as he had his stick lifted trying to make that pass. Still loose in the corner. Ooh. Now it goes to Makarchuk. And it's out off the stick of Bigelow. Reattacking is Matavi. Just fires it to the back wall. Bouncing puck. Controlled by Heyer. Heyer's with a shot.
Wow.
But Polson sees it and is able to hang on.
That was nice. Just looks like he was going to carry it around. And he fired it high in the slot there. And that's a pretty good laser there. Polson was reading it.
Time starting to run out for Lawrence Tech. Not quite to the point where they need to average a goal every 2 minutes, but 8:15, starting to really get to crunch time if you want to make this comeback and get evened up. Sample doesn't get much on that. It's still loose puck, though, in the slot. And Priest couldn't get a shot off. Pedderle has control of it. Pedderle to Matthews. He tries to kick it back outside to Kudenko. Kept alive. This is Priest. Emery away from him. There's a shot on the wall. Silver's out in front. Here it comes out to the point. Sample with the shot.
Oh, they skid it on the screen. I think they got it in the fiver when he was down. Wow, that was good heads up, man. They were battling. They didn't give up.
So Lawrence Tech, they get on the board. Garrett Sample, the even strength goal. And now Lawrence Tech has 7 minutes and 55 seconds to find two more.
It took them 12 minutes and 5 seconds into the third. It took them 52 minutes to get something for them in this effort.
Off the draw, Bird doing his best to tie a guy up, and he does. It comes to West. He just keeps that one moving up ice. And it's not really in a good position to do much with that one. Almost into the Lawrence Tech bench, but it hits the top of the wall. Pulls in.
Ooh.
Plays it over to O'Connell, but almost intercepted.
Yeah, almost fed it. Speaking of which.
Yeah, as I tries to feed it. Comes back to Matavi. Intercepted by Kolinen. He'll just drop it back to Makarchuk as UMD regroups. Over to Emery. Goes back across, trying to find Bird. Bird pokes it past. Here we go with Bird. Bird switching sides with the shot. Rebound there for Kolinen, and it still stays wide. To the near side. Kolinen with it. Goes to West, and he scores a rocket shot.
Wow, on the one-timer there.
We talked about it. There's only so long you can keep Brendan West off the board. He finally strikes for UMD. And it comes at a great time. That one was absolutely torched by Brendan West. He did one of those to Indiana Tech from the right circle a couple of weeks ago, and he absolutely ripped that one even harder.
Yeah, and that was a pretty goal there. And he gets it at the even 13-minute mark.
All right, dumped back in. Into the corner now. Comes up the wall to Gents. Gents will send it over. We've got a broken stick.
Yeah, Potter.
Oh, up to the netting. That is out of play.
Yeah, so Michigan came back and they answered right away to keep this still a 3-goal lead. As it looked like a little bit of momentum could come the way of LT. Think we're having issues again?
Nope, we are good. Sometimes all it takes is a simple plug and unplug. And we should be back in business. And we are. We are good to go. All right. Have that taken care of. I think it was idle for a few minutes, unfortunately. But it is okay.
Nope. O'Connell throws it on the bench. So do we think everyone got to see the West goal at least? We have it captured.
No, it wasn't streaming-wise. Okay. It was clock-wise.
Ah.
So that's the one that we got to watch out for. If it's streaming-wise, it'll start yelling at me. But if it's clock, you just got to hope that at some point it gets noticed.
I step right over it, so I've been trying to just totally avoid it.
It's in a tough spot. That port is, you know, questionable at times anyways. Now here we go back across the line for Matavi, and it's gloved by Colson.
Matavi goes down as he just... They were still looking up for the puck, but coincidental, that's all.
Down to the last 6:14. We've got a little gathering behind the goal here. And it looks like we're all good now. Off the faceoff, and it comes to Pedderle. He's able to get it out. Chasing back to it was Matavi. Pedderle trying to poke it ahead. Kudenko finds it, and he'll work it back to O'Connell. O'Connell now for Makarchuk. up the ice. Kudenko gets a piece of it, and all the way down to Spencer Kroll. He'll play it to Matavi. Looking to find Hickson, and here you go with Hickson in the circle. On goal, and trying to feed. A nice defensive play there by Hartwell.
Got a cross.
Comes across Matavi. His shot. Burr got a piece of it. It still goes through the slot dangerously, though. West with the chip. Now here comes Kolonen. Has Bird with him, but there's a trailer. Kolonen switching sides with Bird with the shot. Kroll with the save. And it's cleared out to safety by Lawrence Tech. Hartwell will rim it back around as we approach the five-minute mark here of the third period. For 55 seconds, Lawrence Tech had it at a two-goal game, and then Brendan West broke free and answered right back and made it three yet again. Hartwell, nearly a dangerous play there, but he's able to survive it. Hem dumps it, but Hartwell doesn't let it get all the way down in the corner. Emery finds the stick of West, and it goes into the Blue Devils zone. Kuntz moving up ice with it. Gets it past Bigelow onto the stick of Pille. Pille bumped off. Timo Ai with the hat trick yesterday, but scoreless so far in this one. Offside now. Lawrence Tech tags up. Makarchuk will hang out behind his own goal. Stretch play up, and icing is going to be waved as it went right through the legs of Kuntz and Bigelow. Up the wall for Hubenschmidt. Icing again waved off as he must have gotten a piece of that one. Matavi, excuse me, that is actually Magdish. Kuntz for I, and he ramps it in. Into the corner goes Bland. Makarchuk there for UMD, under four to play. Potter gets it to Petterly. Petterly dumps it in on goal. Kroll will go ahead and leave it for Hem. Hem almost intercepted by Matthews, but it gets up to Bland, past him to Hartwell. Now Emery with the look. Just goes to Petterly, who had some open ice along this near side, and he chops it in. Comes across to this side for Heyer, trying to take it away from Petterly, as those two had a little stick battle. Now Hartwell centers out in front, looking for the opportunity. Now Matthews will go the other way for Dearborn. He's on as lonesome as his teammates change, trying to make the individual play. He goes backhand too high, and it is up out of play.
Yeah, good recovery on that last effort there, where it almost looked like that the Blue Devils were going to try to get another one there. But you can see what the Wolverines are doing here. They're just cycling through their defense and looking for a good cross-ice pass or stretch pass, and they're just trying to run the rest of this clock out and give no chance for Lawrence Tech to intercept.
Off the faceoff, right back to the live action here. Comes around to Cesarini. Linesman a little bit in the way there, but it ends up being okay. Bird, nice feed from West. There's Bird over to the right circle. Sends it through, nobody over there. His shot goes a bit wide. Makarchuk, as we're under three. West, center out in front, a weird bounce, and they score. It's Bailey Bird.
Oh, man. Kroll could not get a hold of it. His glove was not in the right spot off that. It looked like it was going to be a feed just right out in front of the crease, but none, it just got tipped in there and just padding the lead here. So the Wolverines are setting themselves in the spot they want to be.
Yeah, for UMD. Who knows? Could be a play-in situation with this game for the national tournament. Of course, it looks like they're going to have an automatic bid to play for tomorrow, which would obviously go a long way in securing them a second straight national tournament appearance. But Lawrence Tech, still not done. They're going to probably play this one to the final whistle as their national tournament bid.
Ooh!
As there's a nice shot block from Bigelow.
Bigelow without a stick.
And now Polson without a stick as well. Here's a chance for I, and it's stopped by Polson, who had his stick returned to him. Back to that point for Lawrence Tech. They currently rank number 16, which is pretty safe, not only when you look at auto bids, but when you also look at their average ranking, which is more into the nitty-gritty of how these things are sorted out. Look like they're pretty safe, but you never know. They would have loved that auto bid as well. But for them, should they not be able to come back here? Likely not the end of the road for them. Dearborn, though, not the same situation. They're on the outside looking in as of the moment. Caden Hem looking to get it going here as Lawrence Seck
Good
needs
pass.
To find a goal in each of the next 30-second segments down to the two-minute warning. Aren't going to find one there. It comes around to Sample. He's the lone goal scorer for Lawrence Tech tonight. Hem at the left point. Down along the wall. There's a shot that doesn't get through from Bland. Another try towards the net, but a good defensive effort from Dearborn keeps that one out. Kudenko's stick is tied up. And now Bland back into the corner, watched by Emery. Trying to go right out in front with it. In the corner is Heyer. Not going to pull the goalie.
Yeah,
is Lawrence Tech. So it looks like they're going to just try and play this one out at 5-on-5, but essentially conceding this one, it looks like. There is a penalty on
cross-check.
Well, I thought it was going to be on Dearborn, but Lawrence Tech just had the puck when they blew the whistle. But there was a little bit of time when Heyer still had it.
Well,
it's going to be on Gents.
Yeah, familiar number 19 in the penalty box on a cross-check. With a minute 24 remaining is not what the Blue Devils, they were battling strong. That's not what they wanted to do there. So that should be a real tough uphill climb now.
Yeah, that one should pretty much just seal it. And if Kroll still being in the net didn't kind of give you the indication of where Lawrence Tech thinks they are in this game, I think it's pretty much in stone at this point. We'll just see what the final number ends up being. As Dearborn hunting for more. Across the line, it's I. Wrapping around behind. Had it knocked off his stick.
Pille
has it. Knocked away from him by Bird. Bird will stop up and give it over to Makarchuk as we're now down to the final 60. Kolonen now for West. West brings it ahead, gets around a guy, drops it off for Kolonen. Back looking for West. It does get there, but not for a scoring chance. Colin in the near side corner. Sample takes it away. Bird can't seal it off, and it's sent down the ice. Down to the last 40. UM Dearborn looking to probably just run out the last 30 seconds here as they will advance to a second consecutive WAC tournament championship game. A sour taste in their mouth after last season. A chance for Bird, and it's a nice shot block for Magdish. Emery, he winds and fires, blocked in front by his own teammate, that's Bird. Down to the final 10, we're going to get one last penalty as Bird is put down, and he looks to be in a little bit of discomfort with his bucket, kind of distorted here.
I was a little worried with all those slap shots put on with seconds remaining, something like that would happen, but I didn't think that was going to be a retaliatory hit. But boy, that looked ugly the way he was starting to fold there.
Yeah. So, like I was saying, probably a little sour taste in their mouth for UM Dearborn after last year. Didn't go the way they were hoping for. It was a 6-1 loss against Indiana Tech in the conference tournament championship last year. This year, they'll hope for better. They're putting together quite the run here. Winners in back-to-back days in their last 10 games coming into this. They were 7-2-1. If you would send that out to 12, they're now going to be 9-2-1. This is a team peaking at the right time. And we'll make it official. The buzzer sounds. And the University of Michigan Dearborn Wolverines are going to play for a WAC tournament championship once again.
Yeah, we're going to see the old yellow and blue in there, and so we'll see if they can pull off another one and just keep it between them and Tech throughout the years. But you never know, Concordia may have another surprise up their sleeve. So
so there you have it. It'll be Concordia, the opponent for Dearborn tomorrow, a 1 o'clock puck drop. I'll probably be live here around 12:40-ish, somewhere in that range. We'll get it started with a little pregame action. And then should be a good championship tomorrow for Lawrence Tech. Like I was saying, more than likely not the end of the road for them. But we'll just have to see how everything shakes out when the rankings are released here in the first half of next week. Nonetheless, a tremendous season for them. as this will make their record 26-7-2 overall.
Good season for the Blue Devils.
We're number two in the WAC for almost the entirety of the year. And took down some quality opponents. They've beaten UMD. They've beaten Indiana Tech. They ran the table against every WAC team and won at least one game. But Dearborn, like I said, really coming on strong and peaking at the right time here. But Lawrence Tech just going to recalibrate and get focused up for Nationals outside of Boston in about 3 or 4 weeks.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. Like I said over and over before, this is my favorite part. Everybody's thanking each other for a good battle. We thank them for putting on a good show for us. We just sit here and enjoy it and get to tell you what we see. They're the stars out there, so you know one of them. Thank them for what they've done for us this weekend and this whole conference. But, yeah, you'll be doing that champion tomorrow. Hope it's a good one.
It should be. Looking forward to it. But I think that'll do it for us today. For my cameraman, Connor Hendrickson, my partner in crime on color commentary, Bryce Ryder. My name is Joe Hacker. We thank you for joining us today. This has been the WAC Men's Ice Hockey Tournament, brought to you by SummitCitySports.com.